Unfortunately for him, not involved at all in the T20, which I'm sure he'd be disappointed about because he certainly enjoys his T20 cricket, Billy Godelman. But this season, it's just not to be. Yes, well, tonight you can get catch us, myself and Lauren Tuffery, the Derbyshire Women's Captain. You can catch us on the BBC Sport website and app. We'll have regular updates from throughout Martin's show, so it'll be Bearded Theory and me. There seems to be a connection there. And tomorrow afternoon, we start at Grace Road at 2:30. And again, there'll be updates every half hour throughout the course of summer Saturday. And we will be, once again, Lauren's with me again tomorrow. We'll be at the on the BBC Sport website and app again. Thank you. We'll just stop talking for a bit. Well, Lauren never started, but there we go.
We are just about to get underway here at the Incora County Ground as we prepare. prepare to welcome the players, we want to remind all spectators that we stand against all forms of discrimination and there is no place for it in our sport. We want to embrace and celebrate differences everywhere, knowing that with diversity we are stronger. We're dedicated to raising the game, witness it, challenge it, call it out. Here at Derbyshire, we report by emailing EDI at derbyshirecc.com or speak to your nearest steward. This is now our countdown to life song. Please welcome our two umpires, Chris Lack and David Mills.
Very good evening and welcome to the Incora County Ground. It's the opening game of the T20 Blast for Derbyshire, but not for Birmingham Bears, who played last night and absolutely hammered Northamptonshire. 25 runs they won by in the end. There was a century for Paul Sterling. He actually hit 34 runs from one over. There was a half century from Sam Hain. 3 wickets apiece for Jake Lintott and Danny Briggs. So they're in reasonably good nick, it's fair to say. The Derbyshire players who will be fielding first are getting into a huddle. And alongside me is the Derbyshire women's captain, Lauren Tuffery. Lauren, they've got into a huddle. Is that ever any benefit to anybody?
I think it depends on the players, doesn't it? I mean, we don't really huddle, we stand in a circle. It's the same sort of effect, isn't it?
So they've now come out of the huddle. The music is pounding away. Whether we can hear anything throughout the course of the evening remains to be seen, but we'll do our best to fight our way through the noise, but it's good to have some noise inside a cricket ground. I'll tell you what, it's a very decent crowd indeed inside the Incora County Ground this evening, and it looks to me as though Hayden Kerr might be about to bowl his first ball in English cricket because he's removing his sweater. The Derbyshire numbers have fooled me slightly because they've got dark blue tops with pale blue numbers and names on the back, and I'm not 100% sure that's a good idea, but we'll work with it for the time being. We've got no option, have we, really? And Hayden Kerr, good to get Hayden Kerr into the game nice and early, I suppose.
Yeah, I think it'd be exciting as well. I think a lot of people probably wouldn't have seen much of him before, so a bit of surprise to start the day off with, I think.
If we can persuade him into a pub in Worcester when they play the 4-day game down there, he's going to have to bring his ID. Blimey, he looks about 12 and he's going to be bowling left arm quick from the race course end. So best of luck, young man. He's going to be bowling to Paul Sterling as well, who got the century last evening. There are other games going on tonight. We'll keep you abreast of the scores in those as well as and when we get the opportunity to. Plenty of games going on in the Blast in both North and South groups tonight. Lancashire 64 for one against Yorkshire in the 7th over. In the Northern group, Northamptonshire 75 without loss against Durham. And Northamptonshire were awful last night, awful. I watched the stream, which wasn't much better than they were. Worcestershire 65 for 3 against Notts after 7 overs and 4 balls just up the road at Trent Bridge. So you're up to date with what's happening elsewhere in the Northern group. And umpire Neil Pratt says play. And here we go then. Paul Sterling on strike. There's a slip in place. And Hayden Kerr's first ball in English cricket, he's just pushed out into the offside. That'll settle him down nicely. Talias de Ploy at cover. That's probably the perfect start for Hayden Kerr. Just a nice ball, full of length, on off stump and just pushed into the offside.
Yeah, it's nice to get one where you want it, for straight up. Worst thing is, poor ball, first one.
Nobody wants the poor ball first up. So, Kerr's Derbyshire career is up and running and Paul Sterling has spotted something halfway down the track that he didn't fancy, so he's just removed it and trotted back to his end of the pitch. And here comes Kerr again. In and bowls, and that one is driven with a bit more force. That looks like 4 runs. It is out towards the extra cover boundary. Once it had beaten the inner ring, it was always going to go. And Birmingham are up and running. 4 without loss after a couple of deliveries.
It's a nice shot, that is. Nice, just lent on it. Didn't hit it too hard.
Just eased it, didn't it?
Yeah.
Just
eased straight through the gap.
And there are gaps there. They're actually fielding quite a long way in from the 30-yard circle on the offside. Sam Connors and Lias de Ploy.
Add that bit of pressure as well.
Yeah. They're keeping the slip in place. That'll be Wayne Manson, I imagine, as Kerr is in again, and this time it struck the pad. Big appeal. I think there was an inside edge there. Not out, says umpire Pratt. So we've had a boundary, and we've had a big appeal.
But if it's not hit anything, that's very close. Very close.
I just got the impression that there might have been a little tickle on that one, but what do I know? What do I know? He's walking back slowly to his mark. George Scrimshaw won't bowl in the power play. We'll see Sam Connors, I'd imagine. Mark Watt, possibly. Here's Kerr again, left armour. Over the wicket, bowls to Sterling. He clips this one away into the leg side. That'll be another boundary. You can't bowl there to Paul Sterling. Short, on leg stump. Played away out towards a deep backward square leg. Four. Another boundary. It's eight without loss. Be an update for BBC Radio Derby FM listeners fairly shortly. Then we can get on with the rest of the game and give our undivided attention to the cricket. Fifth delivery of the innings. Eight without loss, Birmingham. And Kerr is in again and bolts. Now again, he just steps into the offside, a single. And this is Dave Fletcher at the Incora County Ground, where we're watching Derbyshire against Birmingham Bears, the Falcons' opening game in the T20 Blast. Birmingham won the toss, decided to have a bat first. They are nine without loss. Paul Sterling, who got a century last night against Northamptonshire, has all of those runs, a couple of boundaries. Hayden Kerr, the Australian, has got one delivery of his first over left. Birmingham, having won the toss and decided to bat, nine without loss. There we go. Now we can concentrate on the cricket till 8:30. So the final ball of the over, it's going to be Jacob Bethel to face the final ball. And he's a left-hander and he's pushed back off a sort of leading edge up towards mid-off, and it's the end of the first over, end of Hayden Kerr's first over. Nine from it, so nine without loss after one over, and he'll just have settled down. I mean, it's bad enough when you make your debut, but when you make your debut 2 days after arriving from India, which isn't even the country that you normally live in, that must be really tricky.
And I think weather-wise, it's going to be a bit of a change as well. Get the body used to it.
Also, Mark Watt's going to bowl the first over from the city, and interesting, bit of left arm spin. Talking to Mark, he's a proper character, Mark Watt. He'll chuck in the 24-yard delivery. He's got a leg spinner. And he got a wicket on Tuesday with the leggy. How good is that?
You love it when you've got different bowlers that can just do different things.
He is.
I like this, bringing on a spinner early on. Just something a little bit different, isn't it?
It'll certainly give Paul Sterling something to think about, you would have thought. It's Scotland against Ireland then, here in Derby. Around the wicket comes Watt, and that's down the leg side and singled wide. 10 without loss. No leeway at all down the leg side for the bowlers in this form of cricket. Any form of white ball cricket. Watt's in again, bowls, and that one is just pushed out into the offside very watchfully by Paul Sterling. I think it's Wayne Madsen who's at long on. There isn't a long off, but there's a long on. There's a man out on the mid-wicket boundary as well. They're the two men outside the circle. Will Sterling take on Mark Watt? He does, and he's got him away out towards a sort of wide, fine leg. He's just helped it on its way, really. It went over Hayden Kerr's head and away to the boundary for four more. Wayne Madsen signals it on our scoreboard. I bet he's thrilled about that. And the score is 14 without loss.
Yeah, just a slight stray of line there and punished for it.
You will be. You will be by players of the calibre of Sterling, who pushes this one out into the mid-off, where unusually we don't find Billy Godleman. We find Shan Masood. Billy Godleman always at mid-off. Certainly in red ball cricket. But not in the T20. Here's Watt again. Round the wicket, bowl slightly short, and that's cut away for four more. This time Harry Kane just moved to his left-hand side. And, he couldn't do anything with it, basically. Just watched it go past. Sam Connors, George Scrimshaw, they'll be thinking about bowling fairly soon, they would have thought. But Mark Watt, well, his first over has gone for nine runs so far. It's 18 without loss. I can't remember what they got in the power play last night. It was something ludicrous. It's next delivery dropped in a little short. It's a genuine edge, and it's down to third man for four more. That is a proper edge of Paul Sterling's bat.
So early on in T20s, sometimes you can just get away with it. Especially when you can only have two out. A little bit of leeway there.
So George Scrimshaw goes a little bit finer or not remains to be seen. I don't think he has for the time being. Here's Watt again. His five deliveries have cost 13 so far. He's in now and bowls, and Sterling covers this one up and pushes it up towards Mark Watt. He doesn't look massively happy with that one. He's overwent for 13 at the end of two overs. It's 22 without loss, but in T20, Lauren, you should never panic, should you? You can't panic after a couple of overs and suddenly say, oh, we need to do something else. You've just got to stick to those plans.
Yeah, and I think this was a good piece of advice I got this year from Catherine Bryce was, in T20s, you've just got to accept that you are going to be hit around the park a little bit. And if you can back yourself and know that, yes, the batters are going to score some runs, but you can always come back. And I think I'm going to take that and say it to everyone going forward.
We're going to see Hayden Kerr bowl a second over from the race course end. Went for 9 in his first. It's over number 3. He's in and bowls, and that one is turned into the leg side by Jacob Bethel. And he's off the mark. It's only the second ball he's faced. Sterling 21 off 11. Bethel 1 off 2. And Sam Connors starts to warm up. Wonder what's going through Sam Connors. He's only played 6 T20s in his career, which means that he's relatively inexperienced at this level.
But it'll be nice to see how he takes to the challenge as well.
Mm. I think he's looking forward to it. He will be delighted. If he is nervous, he'll also be delighted that he's in the team. He wants to miss out the 14. Anish Dahl, Alex Hughes and Mikey Cohen. Here's Hayden Kerr. In again from the racecourse end, balls to Sterling. He just taps it into the leg side. There's a big, big gap there. And eventually George Scrimshaw gets around to do the fielding. They pick up another single. Sterling moves to 22, 24 without loss. And the less music you hear when Derbyshire are bowling, the better.
Yes.
Because that means the ball isn't going to the boundary.
Just a few singles here and there, that's all you need.
I've been more than happy with this so far. A couple of deliveries of the third over. Both have gone for singles. Here is Kerr in again. And this time he dances down the pitch and has a real swing at that one, Bethel, and misses it completely. Might, on another day, have got an edge, and there is a slip in place, Wayne Madsen. Yeah, but it's getting less and less reaction, that bugle, you know, which is really good
news. I miss that sound, though.
Oh, mate, I hate it. There's a number of things I'm not keen. I love the cricket aspect of T20, but some of the stuff that goes around the edges, wait till we hear Sweet Caroline later on. I think I might leave the room. 24 without loss, Birmingham, 2.5 overs gone. Hayden Kerr bowls, and that's pulled into the leg side. There isn't anybody out there. And that's 4 runs to Jacob Bethel, his first boundary. He moves on to 5, and it's 29 without loss in the third.
I think on wickets like this, a bit short of a leg, you're just going to go, because there's such good batting wickets at the moment that Neil and the team are producing here, that if the bowler gets it slightly wrong, batter's just going to jump on it.
The strange thing is as well, Hayden Kerr has been bowling in India. Prior to that, he was bowling in Australia. I mean, there are lengths that you bowl around the world in different countries, aren't there? So
yeah,
it might take him a game or two just to get used to an English length, if you like, which length he needs to bowl. He's in again now and bowls. That one is a play and a miss. Good delivery just outside off stump in that corridor. And Bethel had a go at that one.
The corridor of uncertainty is what we like to call it.
Indeed. Well, he wasn't certain about that. He had a very much a swish at that one outside the off stump. He'd be relatively pleased that he didn't get a touch on that, because if he had, he may well have gone. As it is, it's 28 without loss, with one ball of the third over to be bowled. It's been a good over, this. Just 6 runs off it so far. In goes Kerr and bowls a decent length, and it's driven away beyond the reach of Sam Connors out to the extra cover boundary. And that just spoilt it a little bit. 10 off the over, 32 without loss now after 3 overs, Birmingham. But don't panic. Nobody should panic. This is the power play, and they are expected to get up towards 60 in the power play. That is about a par score these days. And then once you can start putting the fielders out, it starts to get a bit easier to get a bit of a control over the game, doesn't it?
Yeah, yeah, you then can just restrict those runs a little bit easier. But I think what they can take from that last ball, it was up in the air, and all it takes is one mistake and you're gone in T20 cricket. So be a bit of encouragement for the bowlers.
Big moment for Sam Connors here, opening bowler in the red ball game for Derbyshire. Still only a young man, 23 years of age. Hayden Kerr's about the same age anyway. Mark Watt won't be much older, but they're all young men. Here's Connors in and bowls. That's a short delivery. That's a good short delivery. Don't wide it, umpire. Excellent work. Bowled it short. He thought about taking it on there, Paul Sterling. Decided against it in the end, I think.
Like that. Bit of short stuff straight up.
I don't mind
no
it.
No fear from Connors there.
I don't mind it. He'll have a plan. You've got to be thinking two and three balls ahead as well, haven't you, in this form of the game. You can't just come in and bowl top of off. No slips. Mark Watts moved out to the edge of the circle at mid-wicket, and Connors bowls, and that's cut away, and it's no run again. This is a terrific start to the over. It was fielded there by Harry Kame in the covers. And Sam Connors has started with two dot balls. Somebody started early.
Did they say, where's that coming from?
I've no idea. No idea, but he has started it. There he goes again, listen. All the fun of the fair. The lights are on. I'm not sure that we actually need them at the moment, but we're not far away from needing them because it is quite cloudy. This is another short ball, and he's got a top edge on this one. It's gone down. He was aiming towards backward square leg, and it's gone down a short third man, and he picks up a single, Paul Sterling, but a rather fortunate one. Good start, really good start by Sam Connors. He will be pleased. His heart rate will have come down a touch. Shan Masood, who's standing at mid-off, just has a little word with him. Lewis Rees at mid-on. No, I shouldn't have started that really, should I? Lewis deploy at mid-wicket. There's a man out on the square leg boundary, that's Harry Kame. George Scrimshaw is at short, fine leg. Wayne Madsen at backward point. Matty McKiernan at cover. Mark Watt at extra cover. And here is Connor. So there's a third man. I'm happy to say there is a third man as well, because Hayden Kerr down there, I didn't spot him, but he's just emerged from behind the pillar and he's fielded that one as it was guided down to third man. So that's your field for Sam Connors, who concedes another run, but he's conceded two runs off his first four balls. It's 34 without loss.
This is a good over, this is, from Connors, especially with his lack of experience in T20 cricket as well. Really putting himself out there and showing what he can do already.
That was always the concern. You've got to learn somewhere, I suppose. He must have played plenty of T20 cricket. Oh dear, that one's been hoisted for six out towards the players' pavilion. That was an effortless shot from Paul Sterling. He hit a number of sixes last night. I think he hit more sixes than fours last night. That one's gone the distance. That was a magnificent hit from Paul Sterling.
Yeah, that's what you're going to get bowling to experienced players like Paul Sterling. They are going to hit you about. It's how he comes back with this ball, I think, will really show sort of character from Connors.
Blockhole delivery. 29 from 16 now, Paul Sterling. 10 from 7, Jacob Bethel. Final ball of the fourth over. In comes Connors and bowls, and he's pulled away again. Is this a catch for Matty McKiernan? It is. It's a catch for Matty McKiernan. And Paul Sterling has gone. McKiernan with the catch. 29 he made of 17 deliveries, 5 fours and a 6. And what a breakthrough that is for Sam Connors, whose first over goes for just 8 runs.
Exactly what you want, isn't it? Just said, it's how you take your next ball after you've just been hit for a boundary, and he takes a wicket.
It might just have taken a little bit of pace off that one. He's thought, Sterling, oh, this one's another one that I can just ease over the boundary, but they'll be pleased to see the back of Paul Sterling. I don't think there's much doubt about that. And the Bears, the Birmingham Bears, Warwickshire, call them what you will, are 40 for 1. And Matty McKiernan had just removed his sweater and his cap out there in the far distance because he's going to bowl the next over from the race course end. So we've seen left arm spin. We've seen a couple of quick overs from Hayden Kerr, one from Sam Connors, and now we're going to see some leg spin from Matty McKiernan. We had a pretty good T20 blast last season from memory. I do have his figures here. Find them. There we go. Of the players still in the squad, he had the most economical bowling figures, going at just a touch over 7.3 an over. He only picked up 4 wickets, but doesn't go for many, Matty McKiernan. He is on from the race course. And Alex Davis, incidentally, is the new batsman, number 71, former Lancashire wicketkeeper. But it's Jacob Bethel on strike now, the left-hander, and that one comes off an edge down to short third man. There'll be a shot at the stumps here, and the stumps are broken, but they've got through for the single. George Scrimshaw with the fielding. Well taken, quick single. The whole lift, the lift it'll give the whole team as well, picking up the wicket. I mean, that's important, isn't it, at this stage? There's people running around with a spring in their step.
Yeah, that's what you need. When you've gone for a few runs, I think, early on, that wicket just changes it and how the team sort of interacts with each other and puts that bit of pressure on the batters then as well.
McKiernan steadies himself. Short run-up, as you'd expect, for the leg spinner over the wicket. Bowls to Davis, who cuts this one out to point, and Connors does the fielding there at cover. It is very difficult to see these numbers, you know, and I know what they look like, these players. I've been watching them for 6 years. Here's McKiernan again, not all of them, obviously. That one's cut away, and there's a misfield, really, from Hayden Kerr. He sort of dived over the top of that one, which was a little disappointing at backward point. So it's a boundary to Davis to get off the mark. His second delivery. It's 45 for one midway through the fifth over. Think he could have done better there?
I think it's always difficult. I find point is a difficult spot. I think you either stop it or you don't, I think, sometimes.
I'm not suggesting for a moment I could have stopped it. Davis waits. Oh, it's a wild swing at that one. And has he been stumped? No, it's a sort of mis-stumping. He had such a big yahoo at that one. I'm not sure that Brooke Guest was entirely waiting for that ball to come through there.
I don't think he was expecting it to come through. And a little bit of a fumble gave him just enough time to place his bat.
Sort of did a full 360 and slammed his bat on the ground. So he's got away with one there as Alex Davis. Good player. Moved from Lancashire to Birmingham a couple of seasons ago now as McKiernan bowls to him. McKiernan, of course, from Lancashire, from Lee. That one is cut away into the offside and fielded by Sam Connors. Five runs off the over, final ball coming up. Another good over inside the power play. 45 for one as we approach the end of the fifth over. McKiernan in, bowls to Davis, who danced down the track briefly, and that's a much better effort this time by Hayden Kerr. He'd be pleased about that. He dived to his right, got it with his right hand, which of course is his wrong hand, and kept them down to a single as the Derbyshire 12 men come racing on. I can see Anoush Dahl is on, Mikey Cohen as well with caps and all sorts of nonsense. Somebody's had a sweater brought out to me. It's McKiernan. It wasn't McKiernan. It's Liz DePloy who's having a long sleeve sweater. Now here's the thing, George Scrimshaw bowling inside the power play.
It's nice to see him back bowling then.
Oh, no question. I mean, this kid's got talent. Picked up five for against Knox Outlaws on Tuesday in that warm-up game and looked really, really good. So what can he do here? He's going to be bowling to Alex Davis, and he must be about 6'8", and he bowls the full height of his 6'8" plus his arm. They're not quite as long as Twiggy's, but they're quite long. He's in and bowls to Davis, who leaves that one alone outside the off stump. Well bowled, George Scrimshaw. You just can't hit that kind of thing, can you? It's quick and it's short and it's difficult to deal with.
It's one of those ones where you're either going to go at it and it's going to pay off, or you're going to just spoon it in the air and then you're walking back that long way back to the dressing room over there.
Which is something we haven't talked about, actually, but these boundaries, they are big. The normal distance straight, of course, you can't go any further at either end, but wide, good grief, the rope is all the way back to the fence just about. Here's Scrimshaw in again and bowls another short. Now, that's an absolute snorter to Alex Davis, who only just got his head out of the way of that one. I wouldn't have fancied that.
No, not a chance.
It was a quick delivery. The one thing we should have, and I bang on about it almost every time I commentate, we should have a speed gun.
I'd like to know how quick he's bowling, actually.
I would.
It looks like it's coming through quite sharply.
There was a youngster, he was bowling at 90, but of course he had a succession of injuries. Now fit in and bowls to Davis. Now he's ramped him 4-6. Wow. I suppose that's the danger of bowling at the pace that George Grimshaw bowls. If the batsman connects with the ramp, then you're going to go the distance because it's not that long straight. The ball crashes into the advertising boards down below us. And the visitors move on to 52 for one. The half century's up. 52 for one. If you're going to bowl quick, if the bat's only got to touch the ball, really, hasn't it?
Yeah, and that's where sort of pace helps you out as a batter, because sometimes you just get a little bit of bat on it and it's flowing, whereas with the slower bowlers or the spinners, you've really got to put something behind it to get it go the distance. So I think try and get one. It's what I'd do. Try and get one a little bit fuller this ball.
Get it in the block hole. Here is Grimshaw bowls. It's a little bit fuller, but not much. It's turned into the leg side where Mark What does a feeling? Yes, he's wearing 51. Hayden Kerr is wearing 50. Sam Connors is wearing 59. There's an awful lot of fives out there amongst the bowlers. Hayden Kerr just at short, fine leg, which is no position to field at all. It's just the field that you sort of throw away on the edge of the circle, really, when you've got as many people out as you possibly can have. But I wouldn't like to field there. You're too close. It's still fielding restrictions for two more deliveries. 52 for one. Grimshaw is in, and that's driven, but straight to mid-off, where Shan Masood, the Derbyshire skipper, does the fielding. He's doing all right here. Tune, see, in our head. I can do tunes. He's got to keep an eye. We'll be doing an update in about 7 minutes, actually. We've got a long time to wait here. So you'd say the maximum they can get in the power play is 58, and Derbyshire will be quite pleased with that, I think. At the moment, it's 52 for one.
Yeah, I think that's not a bad sort of score in the power plays. Like we said, that it's playing well, this pitch as well.
There is Grimshaw on his way in from the city end, and he's crashed away on a one-handed attempt to take the catch from Harry Kame. He manages to take all the pace off it. That was a terrific effort by Kame on the edge of the circle. Would have been a spectacular effort if he'd clung on to that. He couldn't. 54 for one at the end of the over, so 8 runs off that over. Pretty decent over as well by from George Grimshaw, and that is the end of the power play. They'll be quite pleased, I think, Derbyshire, relatively.
Yeah, I think when you look at obviously where the Bears were yesterday,
yesterday.
You'd want to keep them as restricted as possible, but you know that now it's going to slow down a little bit. You'd hope with the field, extra fielders going out, a little bit more protection. So hopefully Watt will be able to bowl to whatever field he wants. So
this is where Mark Watt comes into his own, I think it's fair to say.
Yeah, he'll thrive under the pressure, and obviously his experience playing international cricket as well is going to help the Derbyshire team alongside Masood, obviously.
Well, it was 2019 when he was here last time, and he was a Scotland international then, but he was by no means the fully-fledged international he has since become with Scotland, and played in a World Cup. As this first delivery is pushed up towards long on by Bethel for a single. He moves to 12 from 9 deliveries, and the Bears to 55 for one. I should have taken more notice last night as to what Birmingham were by the end of the power play, but you can't do it for every game. Blimey, you'd send yourself daft.
You'd forget what's going on if you did that.
Well, forget to eat and all sorts. I wouldn't. Around the wicket comes, well, that's a little bit short, and it's crashed away towards the point boundary where it's fielded by McKinnon out there in the deep. He's got the sun shining straight into his eyes here at the County Ground. This is the perfect example of why they had to turn the square 90 degrees, because I think we'd have stopped by now because of sun in the batsman's eyes a number of years ago. Here's Watt again over the wicket. This one is clipped into the leg side by Bethel. Again, it's McKinnon who does the fielding and gets to the ball quickly, gets it away. Two bounces into the hands of Brooke Guest, the wicket keeper, standing up, of course. We've got men out. Couple on the leg side, the three on the leg side, in fact, and two on the offside there. The field is outside the circle. In comes Watt again, bowls. Oof. Tried a little dab there, did Davis. Missed it. Through to Guest. Four balls of this over gone. 3 runs conceded. Just in again, and pushes it up towards Wayne Madsen, who's filling a long on. Always feels a long on, Wayne Madsen.
Derbyshire will be happy with this. They're just keeping them a little bit quiet. They're going to have to do something to take that run rate up a little bit more.
Current run rate, 8.5. Next delivery. It's a full delivery, and he tries to slog sweep it. Manages to do so, but gets it out as far as Matty McKinn at the end of the over. Mark Watt turns. Job well done, I would suggest. 59 for one at the end of the over, which means there were just five runs off the seventh over, bowled by Mark Watt. George Scrimshaw is going to continue from the city end. They've used five bowlers so far. Kerr, 2 overs for 19. Watt, 2 overs for 18. Connors, 1 over, 1 for 8. McKinnon, 1 over for 6. George Scrimshaw's first over went for just 8 runs as well.
I think it's nice to see so many young kids in today.
Mm. Well, it's been a problem. The competition started on Wednesday, school night. There were games last night, Thursday, school night. This is the first round of matches that have been on a weekend, as this one is played into the leg side by Bethel. And they go through for a single. I'm going to do something clever here, just so that you don't have to listen to any music. I'll do that, do that. Can you hear me?
Yep.
Excellent. So I can hear the music as well now if I need to. There we go. No idea what it is, but it's in my ears, just in case Martin throws to us. Oh, I know who it is. It's Lady Gaga. That song is everywhere. Not a Lady Gaga fan, strangely enough. 60 for one. Scrimshaw, second ball of his over. Bowls, and that's just guided down towards third man. There is a third man. It's Sam Connors. They go through for a single. This is where they're trying to restrict them to a run a ball. Trying to pick up a wicket if they possibly can. The pitch, when we were out, I mean, the pitch looks immaculate, doesn't it?
It does. It's what you want to see as well, is really good wickets, and the team here have been doing a great job this year. And a true credit to them for what they've produced so far.
I wasn't sure if we'd be playing on a hybrid pitch, but Neil tells me 50-over competition is when the hybrid pitches will come into play. Here's Scrimshaw bowling. This one straight up in the air. Chance here for Lewis Rees. He's underneath it. Will he take the catch? He will. Terrific effort. And Jacob Bethel perishes for 14. The second wicket goes down with a score on 61. 61 for 2 now. Birmingham Bears. Bethel 14 from 13 deliveries. A couple of fours. And that's one of those catches, Lauren, that you never won. It goes up into the air. There's cloud, white cloud, grey cloud, blue sky, there's all sorts up there, but he kept his concentration.
It's the white ball in the white clouds as well. We felt that this year. I mean, the ball goes up in the air and everyone just goes silent, and you just sort of like, is someone gonna take it? And you can always hear a pin drop. It felt like that from here, like out there, just there. But a little shuffle to get in the right position, but he looked nice and steady under that reset.
He did. George Scrimshaw, who picked up 14 wickets last season, I think he's got his first of this campaign in his second over. Scrimshaw, 1 for 9 from 9 deliveries. That is pretty decent from George Scrimshaw in his second over. Music out there is blasting over the music. There we go, that was in my ears. But Josh, back at base, has just given me my instructions, so that is excellent. Thank you, Josh. Whether I follow them remains to be seen. Because I've got a very short memory. 61 for 2 then, midway through the 8th over. New batsman is Sam Hain. Got himself a nice half century yesterday. Plays and misses at that first one that he faces from George Scrimshaw, a short delivery again, which is very much George Scrimshaw's stock in trade, I would suggest.
And it's working for him at the moment. He's just firing it in there, you know what you're going to get. And it's up to the batter to just do something with it.
So 61 for 2. Martin's at Bearded Theory this evening. I'm not sure how keen he is to come across to the cricket, but he's doing it for us, which is nice. Another play and a miss. ball by George Scrimshaw to Sam Hayne, his second delivery. It's not looking too bad, Martin. Thank you. Yes, Birmingham Bears, 61 for two. They won the toss, decided to bat first. The not-out batsman is Alex Davis. He's on 16, but we've already seen the end of Paul Sterling for 29 and Jacob Bethel for 14. The wicket's going to Sam Connors and George Scrimshaw, who's currently bowling a very, very good over indeed. In fact, he's just bowled an over, which picked up a wicket and went for just two runs. Bears, after eight overs, 61 for two. There for Martin Williams, who's at Bearded Theory. I think it's Placebo headlining tonight. Patti Smith tomorrow night. Good festival. Patti Smith, blimey, she was going when I was a kid.
I was going to say,
who on earth is Patti Smith? Yeah, no.
I'm normally quite good on my music, but
Because the Night was her song, the song that shot her to. Anyway, I remember it. Here is Matty McKinnon bowling his second over. His first one went for six runs. He's bowling to Alex Davis, who just clips it down the ground. He runs after himself, does McKinnon, but he doesn't have to field it because in off the boundary comes Wayne Madsen to do the fielding. It's 62 for two. That was a terrific over from George Scrimshaw. He's bowled two overs and off the bat has conceded just nine runs. Slight adjustment to the field here as George Scrimshaw himself is asked to move slightly squarer at short fine leg as McKinnon is in and bowls. He showed all his stumps to him there. It's Sam Hayne, but he's got some bat on it, mainly bottom edge. Sam Connors is going to come on and bowl soon, I imagine, because he's just been told by Sean Masood.
Just wait, just give him a little wave. I enjoy a good wave across the field.
Little nod and a wink. Is McKinnon again? That's on the leg stump and turned into the leg side, but there's no run there because around from behind the wickets comes Brooke Guest.
This is good, a bit of pressure on the new batter in as well.
He's faced five deliveries now, Sam Hayne hasn't scored. He got 60 from 30 last night from memory. Played really nicely. He waits now as McKinnon bowls to him, and that's pushed out into the offside. And we all know what happens when there are three dot balls in a row. Well, we saw three dot balls in a row at the end of the previous over and we didn't get the wicket. But now we've had three dot balls in a row in and over. Wicket time for Derbyshire. 62 for two, the Bears. McKinnon is in and Hayne goes back into his crease and just guides it out towards the point boundary. The throw comes in from Mark White. It's a decent enough throw, but it's an awful long way out there. I'd probably prefer to have got a taxi from there.
It's good running as well, though. Really, Hayne's just set off very quickly and he was coming back no matter what, I think, there.
So Hayne is off the mark. Bears up to 64 for two. We're in the ninth over. Approaching the halfway stage. McKinnon is in again and Hayne again goes back into the leg side and just guides it out into the offside where it's fielded by Mark Watt. Four runs off the over. 65. 4-2 at the end of that one. McKinnon, two overs for 10. Terrific effort from the leg spinner. Scrimshaw, two overs, one for 9. Really good effort from the big quick. And here's Wayne Madsen. It was Wayne Madsen he was not waving to.
It wasn't
Sam Connors. Wayne Madsen's going to come on to bowl the 10th over.
Well, they're seeing that the spinners are sort of holding it up a little bit as well. So keeping from the slow bowling, I think, will be an interesting choice and see what he does.
Absolutely. He's a canny operator though, Wayne Madsen. He's been doing it for years. He's the man with the most T20 appearances in this Derbyshire side.
Okay, he's directing his fielders exactly where he wants him.
And the other thing that Wayne Madsen can do as well, if the batsmen allow him, is get through an over like that in next to no time, and before you know what's happened, another over's disappeared from the number of overs you've got available.
That's what you want as well, isn't it? That's that added pressure.
Here he comes then, Wayne Madsen from the city, and he's been smashed down the ground by Hayne, and it's hit Davis, and there's no run. That's a little unfortunate for the Bears and very good fortune for Derbyshire. Hit Hayne, Davis rather, on the back, and I think he's probably going to be in a bit of pain there.
Yeah, He has definitely worn that one.
Well, he was fortunate that he turned his back on it. He just dropped his bat on the ground. Shan Massoud's gone across to make sure that they're all right. Wayne Madsen won't want to have seen the batsman get hurt, but of course it was batter on batter, really, wasn't it? One batter's battered the other.
It's also saved a boundary.
It did indeed.
He hit it quite straight, so he's hit it hard, quite straight. Long on would do well to get round to it, I think, on that one.
Yes, you wouldn't have backed the long on, would you? Elsewhere in the Northern Group then, Northamptonshire in the 17th over are up 190 for 3 against Durham, that's at Montage Road. Worcestershire 154 for 6, they're in the, they've got 2 overs left there at Trent Bridge against Nottinghamshire, of course. Lancashire 132 for 4 in the Roses match, that's been played at Old Trafford, they're in the 17th over there. In the Southern Group, Glamorgan 128 for 3 against Surrey at the Oval. 16 overs and 5 balls gone there. They're in the 11th over at Canterbury, where Kent are 87 for 2. That's against Essex. Gloucestershire 146 for 4 against Sussex in the 17th over at Bristol. And Middlesex are 67 for 3 in the 10th over against Hampshire. And that game's being played in Southampton, and I'm delighted to say that Alex Davies is okay to continue. The physio's been out, giving him a little rub. Might take more than that, he'll have a very nice bruise there. Probably when he wakes up tomorrow, he might not be able to lie down on his back tonight. Here's Madsen in again from the City End. Bowls, and that one's clipped up towards long on by Sam Hain. Trying to work out who that fielder is, but I've got absolutely no chance. It's Matty McKinnon out in the far distance.
Did you get that from the number?
Yeah.
I need my glasses on, I think.
Yeah. Long way away, I'm not too bad, but if they're quite close, I'm in trouble. I should be able to get it from the way they run. Madsen's in again, and this one's pushed again up towards long on Madsen. That was into the ground. Madsen dived across to the right. Some supporters in the ground, I think, thought that might have been a catch. He was desperately trying to get across and stop it. Another single added to the total, 67, 4-2 partnership, 6 off 11, off 12, I beg your pardon, is this one. Now that it's been driven straight back down the ground, and 6, just manages to creep over the boundary rope. Yeah, Matty McKinnon confirms it, and now the umpire, David Milnes as well, they've just put the 4 up on the big screen. They're going to have to change that to 6, I'm afraid, because there we go, it's been changed to 6. It was a very straight blow. There was an attempt, a diving attempt, by the fielder at long off, who at the moment I'm not 100% sure who it is.
Is it Reese?
Could be. Now that he's gone into the leg side this time, just watch out for the spin. They do watch out for the spin. That's Kerr, because he's thrown it in with his left arm. Hain moves on to 11, 74 for 2. No, it's not. It's Lear's deploy. Oh dear. Oh, Hayden Kerr's down here at short, fine leg. It's the vice-captain, Lear's deploy, out there in the distance. This one has been pulled into the leg side by Davis. Again, it's deploy who gets there. Now then, they're coming back for the second, and they're going to get back comfortably enough in the end. That was good running from Hain. They do get back. End of the over, 76 for 2. So 11 off that over. That was a slightly disappointing over from Wayne Madsen. What over for them? That is the halfway stage, though. 76 4-2 Birmingham, who last night made in excess of 200 in 16 overs. So Derbyshire have certainly kept more of a lid on the Birmingham batters than the North Ants managed last night.
Yeah, they bowled some good balls and sort of led some sort of dry spells for the batters as well. So it's been down to them to really sort of make something happen.
Mark Watt's going to be bowling to Sam Hain. He's on 11. Round the wicket he comes, and Hain plays, misses, and is stumped. That's an excellent little bit of work from Brooke Guest behind the stump. So Mark Watt's got his first wicket on his return to Derbyshire. He's given out on the big screen by a moustacheless George Scrimshaw. I'm glad to say he's got his moustache back now, but that's excellent work. And Hain goes for 11.
Quick work there from Brooke Guest. Top guy, Brooke Guest is.
He's a very good keeper as well.
Well, his wicket keeping has improved beyond all recognition from when he first started. When he first started, I think we saw him up at Durham. I could be mistaken. It could have been somewhere else. And nothing seemed to stick. But I don't think he'd done it for a while. And it does take a while to get into the rhythm of wicket keeping, doesn't it?
Yeah, I mean, I'm by no means a wicket keeper. But when I did it that one time, stepping in, it took me, I was warming up for a couple of hours just trying to catch the ball cleanly. So you can imagine our shock when there was one edge behind and I'm jumping up and down and it's stuck in the glove.
The worst thing is the up and down. It's harsh on the lower back and the hamstring, isn't it?
Next day.
Not surprised.
No go for
me. No, not surprised.
A lot of respect for anyone who keeps for a living.
Oh, fair play for doing it. Fair play for doing it. The new batsman is Adam Hose. It is. And he will be on strike. So wickets for Watt, Connors and Scrimshaw so far this evening. Good start for Derbyshire, 76 for 3. Good to have Colin Knifton along. Hope he's okay over there in the Isle of Man as Watt bowls around the wicket and it's driven out into the point region. That looks like Matty McKiernan. Good piece of fielding, good throw, McKiernan. And it keeps him down to a single. Hose off the mark. Straight away at Flex Sport. If you want to get in touch via Twitter, I'm not sure I'm going to have time to read the emails, but you can send me one. This one is pushed out into the offside by Davis, fielded by Shan Massoud. There's an extra cover. There's a long off and a long on.
He's looked like he's bowled that one from quite far behind the crease line.
Does it? 24 yarder. Yeah, he said he'd sneaked a couple in on Tuesday. I haven't seen the leg spinner necessarily yet, unless that was the one that got him out. I didn't read it, didn't pick it. Ball is played into the leg side and fielded by Lewis de Ploy. And another single added to the score, 78 for 3. Yes, he did it last time when he was here in 2019, and we were all amazed by it, but we got used to it in the end. He told me on Tuesday, there he goes again, 24 yards, and that one is pushed out into the offside, and it's once again fielded by Shan Massoud. It's just to surprise the batsman, but he said he surprised Shan Massoud when he did it on Tuesday. He wasn't ready, and he was still chatting to somebody else, so he's going to try and work out a signal so that he knew. This one's from 22 yards this time, and it's driven down the ground. It's only going to be a single, because it's fielded by Sam Connors.
We found him.
He throws it back in at the end of the over. Just three runs from it, 79 for 3 now. And that was a really good over after that 11-run over from Wayne Madsen that they tried to sneak in. So we've used, six bowlers so far, which just takes the pressure off a little bit. Although Sam Connors has only bowled one over, it's going to be George Scrimshaw to continue from the city end. Hayden Kerr's bowled 2, Mark Watts bowled 3 now, 1 for 21. George Scrimshaw will be bowling his third over here. McKinnon's bowled a couple of Wayne Madsen's bowled one, and that applause is for Mark Watt. He's such a nice bloke. He said that what I said to him about the bowling from 24 yards is that he did it in the World Cup in the group matches and then in the World Cup itself. And the commentators on television were absolutely staggered. And I said, we saw that 3 years ago. And he said, oh, yeah.
We already knew.
Yeah, we knew what you were going to do. What he didn't have last time was the leg spinner and various other bits and pieces, the various tricks that the spinner requires. And so here comes George Scrimshaw from the City End bowling to Adam Hose, who defends it up to mid-off.
So it's a rare fuller ball from Scrimshaw there.
Yes, good spot. Good spot. Yes, he doesn't bowl many, I think it's fair to say.
Yeah. Well, they're the type of deliveries that are going to throw a batter off.
Well, he wouldn't necessarily have been expecting it, would he?
Yeah, he'd be ready for one round by the chin.
Tim Chambers, good to hear from you, Tim. Early days, but I like the balance of this Derbyshire side in the field. All sorts of options with the ball, and Scrimshaw is much of a handful as I had hoped. And he bowls this time, and he's cracked away to the point boundary where it's fumbled initially by Harry Kame out there, but he recovers nicely, throws the ball in. Not taken cleanly by wicketkeeper Brooke Guest, but well backed up by Wayne Madsen. Another single to the score. Hose moves to 3. 80 for 3. The ball is travelling, isn't it, when it gets hit out there?
It is. It's flying across the outfield today.
I had a walk out on it. I've been on it a couple of times today, once when David Griffin had his drone out there. had a chat with the ground staff and the ones for the toss. It is beautiful out there. You'd be proud of it if it was your back garden, I'll tell you. Here is Scrimshaw bowling a slower delivery. It's pulled around the corner. There is a fielder down there at backward square leg. It's Sam Connors, I fancy. And he does the fielding. Keeps him down to a single again. Hose picks up. No, he doesn't. Davis picks up one more. Moves to 22 from 21. 81 for three. Things do happen very quickly in T20 cricket. And I've just been used to 6 games of four-day cricket where you can basically relax for much of the day. Don't tell anybody that. That's what I do. But this is high-speed cricket as Scrimshaw is in and bowls. And that one is turned into the leg side by Hose. They've run the first one quickly. In comes Connors again. Picks up nicely and throws it in. And keeps them down to a single. Hose moves to 4. 82. 4-3. No, I think they can do away with the bugle now, in all honesty.
Didn't get a great
doesn't,
response.
It doesn't.
It might a bit later on.
Do you think?
Let everyone
the queues at the,
go to the bar
queues at the
bit.
Bars aren't that big at the moment, but yes, I know what you're saying. An awful lot of music, really, which is all to Derbyshire's advantage. Here's Scrimshaw bowls. That one is pulled into the leg side. Is it between the two fielders? It is. That's well placed by Alex Davis. And there is the music. He moves on to 26 from 22 deliveries. 86 for three now. And another short ball from George Scrimshaw. So when Lauren pointed out the full length delivery, they're the exception rather than the rule. And he's now conceded from his 3 overs, minus one delivery. It's just 16 runs.
Well, that's going to help the Bears' run rate a little bit as well. It had dropped down to just 7. I mean, it's gone back to 7.3 now, but
Scrimshaw, he almost plays it on there. He tries to pull it into the leg side, Davis. He's got away with one there. It bounces into the ground and misses the stumps, and there's almost an overthrow. There isn't. It's the end of the over. 86-4-3 after the George Scrimshaw over. How many runs off that one? I don't know. I should just add them up on the screen in front of me, but I was trying to do some maths there. 87-4-3, and we've had 12 overs.
Well, Davis got away with that last one.
Didn't he?
Snuck a little sneaky single there. Keep the strike. McKernan's coming back on for his third.
I thought it'd be clever and do these sheets, but I don't like them. I don't like them already. I'm going to have to do some. I've got 15 of them here for the whole season. I don't like them. I'll do some else tomorrow. I'll get used to it by the finals day. McKernan in and bowls to Davis, who just turns this into the leg side. Gets to the edge of the 30-yard circle. They're coming back for a second now. The throw's on its way. McKernan removes the stumps, or the bales, when it demolishes the stumps.
Taking all the stumps out of the ground.
He's gone for the lot there, hasn't he? And they do get back for a second. Liz deploy with the throw. But Matthew McKernan was less than subtle as he turned, having gathered the ball and basically demolished the stumps. 89 for three now with that couple of runs from the first ball of the Matty McKernan over. This next one is a play and a miss. In fact, it's caught behind. He's been given. He doesn't like it, Davis. Doesn't like it at all. He eventually puts his bat under his arm. There was no doubt in the bowler's mind or the wicketkeeper's mind. Davis didn't like it, but he's gone for 29. It's 89 for four.
That's a sharp catch, I guess that is.
And when you see the bowler and the batsman go up like that, it was instantaneous, wasn't it? It wasn't like, well, we'll appeal after this one. The impression that we get is that he hit it. Davis didn't really
look like he was convinced, was he? No, he wasn't. But, you know, you feel like you know as a bowler, with the limited bowling experience that I have, when you do take an edge, you do know about it, and you've got a good keeper to back you up and shout up about it. It's what you need, and they've done a job there.
And part of T20 as well, they got one wicket in the power play, but they've since got wickets in the 8th, the 11th and now the 13th over. If you keep taking wickets, it keeps the run rate down.
Yeah, it makes it harder for those batters coming in as well. Like, they've got to start from scratch again. I mean, it's a good wicket, so it doesn't take too long to get in. But with the tight bowling that Derbyshire have got at the moment, It's going to be a challenge to start hitting those boundaries, which I think at this point Bears could do with a few more of them.
We saw Paul Sterling hit a six out to the longest part of the boundary square, but these boundaries are very, very big, which means that Derbyshire won't necessarily find the boundary as often as they perhaps might, as McKinnon is in and bowls. This one's pushed out into the offside, and they pick up a single. It's fielded by Sam Connors. Good fielding as well. He's a good fielder, Sam Connors.
It's good to see like how strong they are in the field as well. And I know I said last time I was on about the hard work they've been putting in, but they are doing so much work now.
Keenan bowls, and that one is on the stumps and clouted into the offside, fielded by Massoud. It's one area that you can work on and can improve on in quite a quick space of time, really, as McKinnon comes in and bowls. It's driven down the ground by Hose. Picks up a single out to Mark Watt at long off.
I think fielding is one of those skills that not a lot of people focus on. A lot of people like, you're a batter or you're a bowler, but what we like to tell everybody is everyone has to field, so you've got to enjoy it and actually put the effort into doing it.
McKinnon in again, this time bowling to the new batsman, who is Chris Benjamin. He cuts that out into the offside and they only get a single. So Benjamin is off the mark, end of the over. 92 for four. He's already off the mark. But that was a very good over for Matty McKinnon. You can see that just five runs, picked up a wicket as well. Exactly what you want in the 13th over. Exactly what you want at any time in a T20, but just keeps a little tag on the run rate. Sam Connors returning from the city end. Chris Benjamin was one of the players who benefited last year from the 100, wasn't he? He picked up a contract and scored a few runs.
Yeah, and I think that sort of cricket is going to help in terms of hitting those bigger shots, isn't it? Gives them that time to play shorter format of cricket.
He's just practiced a shot that would provide a catch for the man out at mid-wicket. Let's see what he does as Sam Connors begins his second over. Bowls, and that's down the leg side. That'll be a wide. It is. There is no leeway in this form of cricket, or any form of white ball cricket, for the ball down the leg side, sadly. So as a result, I'll have to bowl that one again. Run rate 7.1 and 6.4 in the last five overs. In comes Connors again. That's a bowl, a better delivery. In fact, it strikes Benjamin. It'd pick up a leg by for that one. That was a quicker ball. You could hear the effort in Sam Connors' grunt as he delivered that one.
What's your thoughts on the grunt from a bowler?
It sort of gives away, well, you see, now it could be a double bluff, couldn't it, these days? But yeah, the grunt is sort of signifies the effort ball, but you could grunt when you were bowling a slower ball so that
see,
the batsman...
that happened to me at the weekend.
Oh, no.
Somebody was bowling, all of a sudden a grunt, and I was like, where does that come from?
Connors bowls, no grunt. That one's pushed out into the offside. It'll be fielded by Mark Watt, go through for a single. Hose moves on to 6.95 for four. So you played the shot too quickly? Too early?
No, I didn't get out. I was just a bit,
right.
A bit baffled
that's
by
okay.
Where
no,
this
that's
noise
not too
come
bad.
From.
But yeah, a bit like the tennis players, you grunt. That sort of becomes a habit, I think. 95 for four. Connors is in. That one is turned into the leg side off something. Glove,
another,
possibly.
Another leg by, maybe.
Yeah.
Nope.
But that doesn't signal anything, David Milne, so perhaps off his glove, because there was no noise at all. 96 for four. Shan Massoud pointing. Just wants Mark Watt on the edge of the 30-yard circle at extra cover.
He looks like he knows exactly what he wants to do with his field today,
yeah.
Massoud does.
He does. He's done it before, the lad. This one out, then. This is lifted high. That's going to be six runs. It's into the car park. Bang, and it bounces off one of the concession stands. The people standing waiting for burgers and fries might have got a shock there, because that one's gone quite a long way. One of the stewards has to go around and see if he can find the ball. That was a big, big hit from Adam Hose. He moves on to 12, and the 100's up for Birmingham. 102 for four, but he hit that cleanly.
He did. It looked like it was just in the slot, wasn't it? Like they like to say. work through it nicely, and now they're going to have to try and find the ball again.
Yeah,
it's not going anywhere near my car.
Is your car in there?
My car's over there.
Oh no, mine's behind the media centre. I'm all right, you see. I always park it behind the media centre because I've only ever seen it cleared once. That was by Alex Hughes.
That would be a good shot to clear and go
and
down.
And get it down again,
well,
yes. It would have to go a long way up, wouldn't it? It would have to go a long, long way up. Carlos Brathwaite due in next, then Henry Brooks, Danny Briggs, Jake Lintott and Craig Miles for the Birmingham Bears. They're still looking for the ball, so it gives me the opportunity to give you the scores at the innings break in some of the other games in the Northern Group. Worcestershire finished on, I don't know, it's disappeared. How could that possibly disappear? Worcestershire finished on 164 for 9 against Nottinghamshire at Trent Bridge. Northamptonshire made 223 for 4 against Durham. Wantage Road, and Lancashire 183 for 7 against Yorkshire at Old Trafford. Innings break as well at Bristol, by Gloucestershire 193 for 7 against Sussex. Glamorgan 173 for 5 against Surrey at the Oval. So they're all the games at the halfway stage. A couple of other 7 o'clock starts. Middlesex 111 for 4 after 15 overs against Hampshire. And what's the other game? There it is. Kent, 128 for 4 against Essex after 15 overs and 4 balls. 102 for 4 here. 13 overs and 4 balls have been bowled by Derbyshire. That's a better delivery from Sam Connors. He went for length and the ball has barely made it to the edge of the 30-yard circle, and they're going to come back for a second run.
It's good batting, that is. Everyone's out on the field, over on the leg side. Drop it for a quick 2. Especially after that nice 6 as well.
Yeah, no need to hit every ball out of the ground. Sean Massoud said something to me the other day as well about how many boundaries you'll get in a T20. In comes Connors again and bowls, and that one is played into the leg side. They'll get through for a single. Oh, not taken cleanly by Brooke Guest. I think it's Wayne Matson with the throw. It might not have been. End of the over, 105. 4-4, so 13 runs off that Sam Connors over. He's now gone for 20 in his 2 overs so far. It was going to be a big ask for Sam Connors, as Matty McKinnon is going to bowl his final over. 3 overs, 1 for 15 so far. A couple of tweets, Tim Chambers and Chris Bridden encouragingly watched the 2 T20 wins over Yorkshire by the second team today as well. He says things are looking up. Tim Chambers said he popped down for an hour. Surprised how poor the Yorkshire bowling was. Never be surprised about how poor Yorkshire are. McKinnon bowls, and the ball is played straight back to him by Adam Hose.
McKinnon's done a really good job here so far, and I think if he can just come out of this over as less runs as possible.
He's bowling again, and this one slapped out into the offside. Sam Massoud says, I can't get that. So he allows Sam Connors to come around and do the fielding. That's what the captain's allowed to do. Just point.
I enjoy a good point. You look at it again, yes, there's someone there.
Over there.
That's yours.
Over there.
Okay, just a slight tweak in the field as well.
McKinnon blows into his hand about 4 times before he bowls every single delivery. He's in now, and this one is a swing and a miss, a real hoik. Might have got a bottom edge on it, Adam Hose, but it was straight into his pad and out into the offside.
I think that's clearing the marquee, that is, if he's connected with that. Getting closer and closer.
It's going to Utoxeter if he connects with that. My car might have been in danger. Here comes McKinnon again, another huge swing and a hoik, and it's got an inside edge, and Scrimshaw's chasing it down towards the boundary and gets there, keeps it in, nice work, and it's thrown back in by Hayden Kerr down at the far end, and Hose comes back for a second. Good work all round, really. McKinnon's bowling nicely here. Wayne Madsen just managed to turn around and say, come on, Matt, while he was running back to the boundary. Sorry.
See, you've got to get it in when you can.
109 for 4. 2 balls of his full over spell.
The field as well, yeah. Covers come a bit straighter.
McKinnon balls, reverse sweep comes out. He has a cursory appeal for leg before wicket. And they pick up a run. So the appeal for leg before wicket was never going to succeed because the batsman's been given the run. 110 for 4. Hose just stretches out his hamstring. We've now got a man out on the backward point boundary.
That's Connors as well. He's come in from the cover boundary.
He has. He's come into extra cover. All change. Final ball of McKeelan's over. He's in and bowls, and there's a slap out into the offside by Chris Benjamin. He picks up another single. End of the over, just six from it. 111 for four. Matty McKeelan, four overs, one for 21. Terrific effort by him.
Absolutely. He's done a great job there. Not gone for too many. Kept it tight. And taken a wicket as well.
A good evening so far. Here comes George Scrimshaw again. So it'll be his last over, will it? It will. He's bowled three overs, one for 17 so far. Update for FM listeners coming up out of the 8 o'clock news. George Scrimshaw, what's he? Oh, he's not going to bowl. Interesting. Change their minds. It's going to be Mark Watt. But they definitely said Scrimshaw.
They did. He just chucked his jumper back on and they forced.
He's not injured, I'm happy
to
say.
Come back on the pitch. Get his steps in.
Well, just a change of mind from Shan Masood there. It's his prerogative. He's the captain. He can do what he wants. Mark Watt has bowled at three overs for 21. Here we go, update. This is Dave Fletcher at the Incora County Ground, where Derbyshire are taking on the Birmingham Bears in their opening T20 Blast game of the season. Birmingham won the toss, decided to bat first, and Derbyshire have done pretty well. They're 111 for four as we stand. We're in the 15th, or just about to start, the 16th over. In fact, Paul Sterling and Alex Davis both scoring 29 wickets for Mark Watt, Sam Connors, Matty McKiernan, and George Scrimshaw. Five overs to go then, and Birmingham Bears, who won the toss, decided to bat first, are 111 for four. Update complete. Like a pro. 112 for four as that ball was played somewhere.
It was played down to mid-on.
Thank you.
For a single. Did almost take out Benjamin as well.
Ah. Uh-huh.
No? Hose. Benjamin almost took Hose out.
Yes, Hose is on strike now. Yes. He's got 20 from 17. This partnership, 23 off 17 delivery. Watt around the wicket bowls to a full toss that's crashed away. Poor delivery from Mark Watt. A rare poor delivery in recent times, really. It was a full toss. And Hose moves up to 24, 116 for four. Seen too many of those, Lauren?
No, and I think he's just sort of dropped it a tad bit too short outside the off stump, and he's just carved it away to the point boundary.
Next delivery from what is a little bit short, and that's up in the air, out towards the boundary. It's going to be six. It is six. It's over the covers, which are beyond the boundary's edge, and this has not been a great over from Mark Watt. We haven't said that so far this evening. He's now gone for 32 runs. He's gone for 11 in his first three balls of his final over, and you just wonder whether the fact that George Scrimshaw was going to be bowling and then they changed their mind and brought Mark Watt on, whether he wasn't quite ready. But anyway, he's in now. He'd be angry. He bowls, and this one is pushed up towards long on, where Wayne Madsen probably does the fielding away in the far distance. It is. It is Wayne, yeah. It's Wayne. It's almost certainly where you would expect him to be. What again? This one's carved into the leg side. Is it going to be a catch? It's over the fielder and all the way over the boundary for six more. The fielder out there in the far distance leapt to his full height. Unfortunately, his full height wasn't high enough. Matty McKiernan, it's six more.
Thought the 24-yarder had done it then.
Yeah.
I'm spotting it now. I'm working it out.
Benjamin moves on to 11, 129 for four. 11 from 7, Benjamin. What is in again? And this one is smashed down the ground. Is it going to go? Oh, it is. It's miles over Wayne Madsen. He gave up very early there. And it's into the bound, into the crowd for 6. A crowd catch as well. Benjamin moves on to 17 at the end of the over. 135 for 4. That's made a massive difference. 24 runs off the over. Huge over for Birmingham. Poor old Mark Watt finishes with 4 overs, 1 for 45. He's taken a bit of a pasting in that over, I'm afraid, the Scot. 4 overs to go, 1-3-5 for 4.
I think that's the type of over that the Bears have been waiting for. I mean, they were just ticking along, not really scoring many boundaries. I mean, their run rate is now up to 8.4, which is not massive for T20 cricket, but from where they were a couple of overs ago, they were just above 7, so going to make a bit of a difference. That.
You do wonder, because George Grimshaw was definitely told to strip and get ready to bowl, wasn't he? And then they changed their mind and brought Mark Watt on, and whether Watt wasn't quite in the right frame of mind, whether you have to be in the right frame of mind to bowl, I've no idea.
Yeah, I think that's the thing. I know some of my players have said before, like, can I have some decent warning before I bowl? And maybe that's had a bit of an effect on it.
Hayden Kerr's back bowling, and that's how I was just guiding it to a backward point. Pick up another single. So 136, nobody needed to know that. 136 for 4. They may have seen it though, because
there's this button, you see, well, which you told me all
I know. I sort of know how these things work, but I quite often forget. And I could do something. I could just remove that, take that out of there, and then put that in there, and put that in my bag, and there's one thing already packed up for later on. There's still a little bit of discussion between Hayden Kerr and Shan Masood as to where he wants his field. He seems quite happy. The young New South Welshman.
Yeah. Madsen's come in.
Madsen's come up, and the man down at fine leg has gone back.
Okay. Shorter ball I'm going for.
Double bluff, I'm saying. It's a double bluff. It's a full delivery. It almost gets through. Inside edge. See, that's 1-0 to me.
That's it.
1-0 to me.
We'll keep a tally.
Yeah. Over the course of the season, you'll win far more than I do, I can tell you. I'm just going to say the opposite of what you say. And eventually... You will be right.
I'll get it wrong.
You'll be right more often than you're not.
There you go, Madsen and Connors have gone back out onto the
full delivery.
Long on and long off boundary.
So we're going full delivery.
This will be short, this one.
There's a man out of the square leg boundary. Another man out on the mid-wicket boundary as well. As Hayden Kerr is in to bowl to Adam Hose. And he's strapped at leg before. No, he's not. It was a half-hearted appeal, actually. I don't know why I thought it was ever going to be out. It was outside the line of the off stump.
It's always difficult, isn't it, for a left-armer to get an RB, especially now when the ball's not really doing much in terms of swing and stuff like that. I don't think I'd have gone up for that one.
Oh, I probably would, but more in celebration of actually reaching the crease. 138 for 4. Benjamin on at 18 on strike, and that one is, lifted miles, absolutely miles, out to the marquee and into the...
Into the window.
Yes, into one of the windows of the marquee, away to our right-hand side. That was a very, very big shot.
Kerr's having a bit of a stretch there.
That's not good.
You don't want to be seeing that.
No. Is he all right? Is he stretching out? Is it his left calf or Achilles? And he is limping a little bit. Hope he's okay. The last thing Derbyshire want is they're overseas to be injured. Is he going to carry on? Yeah, he's going to carry on, the lad. I think he's just got a bit of cramp. Oh no, he's limping now, and he's... Wayne Madsen, very correctly, is coming across to say, look, if you're not right, get yourself off. There was some concern here from Shan Masood. Oh, hamstring, he's suggesting there. Is he?
Yeah, definitely. He keeps pointing at his hamstring.
Oh my word. Wayne Madsen with his hands on his hips. They can't catch a break at the moment. Derbyshire injuries in recent times. Anuj Dahl and Lewis Reed, who is playing. Anuj Dahl is available, so at least he could come in tomorrow. The new man on his debut. No, he's going to carry on. He's all right. The physio's coming on, though. Julian, the physio, he's got a third of the way there. And now he's going off, and the 12th men are
dropped all the stuff,
dropping
on the
bottles everywhere. And...
Oh, he's having a mare. He keeps dropping it. There we go.
He keeps shaking that left leg. I think it's cramp. I think he thinks it's cramp. He thinks it's cramp. Otherwise, he wouldn't risk it, would he? Let's have a look and see if he can get through this delivery. He's bowling to Chris Benjamin. He's in and bowls to him, and he's carved away out into the offside. There isn't anybody out there. That's four more. Benjamin moves on to 28.
Well, he's walking better.
Yes, he is, isn't he? Yeah. I've just written hamstring ? Down next to him in the my bowling column, but I think he's okay. Benjamin moves on to 28. 148 for four with three overs to go. It's still not got out of hand from a Derbyshire perspective. 8.5 and over.
They definitely picked it up, haven't they, the Bears?
Yeah, they have. Yeah, in the last five overs, they're going at 12s. 12.5. Here is Kerr, and again, oh, and that's a good delivery that goes straight through the batsman. Benjamin misses, and then the ball is thrown back by Brooke Guest and almost clonks Hayden Kerr on the head. That's about the last thing you needed there. 148 for four, 13 runs off the over, so 37 runs off the last two overs. It's what you'd expect at this stage of a T20. There's only three overs to go, and they've only got 148 for four. They'll be looking for a big finish here, and George Scrimshaw is going to bowl, unless he changes his mind and he puts his sweater back on. The 18th over so far, Scrimshaw, three overs, one for 17. Can he pick up a second wicket? Can it be as economical? Tall order on both fronts. Both batsmen relatively set now. Benjamin, 28 from 12. Hose, 32 from 22. The partnership, 59. From 28. Here comes George Scrimshaw in and bowls to Adam Hose, who that one's down the leg side. That'll be wide.
No, oh, it was a fuller ball.
It was. No leeway, though. You just don't get a chance, do you? Down the leg side. Yes, Nick, not another injury for the bowlers. He says Nick Hartsall. Oh, he feels. Tore his left calf muscle on Sunday during his fourth over. Oh, no. Here is Scrimshaw in again and bowls. Oh, that's huge.
That is huge.
Out to the leg side and to the back of the stand in front of the players' pavilion. That is massive.
It's down there, the family stand, that is. The kids all be there like this.
Yeah.
Arms in the air.
Losing the teeth. That was enormous. Hose moves to 38 from 23. The Bears to 155.
His line just seems to be drifting slightly towards the leg side, and I think if he can just sort of bring it back a little bit, come back strong on this ball.
He's got three inside the ring on the offside and only one on the leg side. This is another short ball that's pulled into the leg side. Sam Connors is out there. He keeps him down to a single. Hose moves to 39, 156. 4-4. A word between Sean Massoud and Brooke Guest. Wicketkeepers see an awful lot, don't they?
Yeah, they have got one of the best views of the game, and you're constantly in the game as a keeper as well. And I know I always look to my keeper for a bit of help in terms of where the fielder should be and what everything's looking like from where I can't see it from my nice little spot.
4 sixes in the last 13 balls. There's a big swing and a miss there. It's come down fine to third leg. Mark, what will field it? That'll be a leg by, I fancy. No, he's got some bat on it. Well fielded by Watt down below. So that run quite a long way there, did Mark Watt. 157 for four. Benjamin moves up to 29.
29 or 13. It's just been going along a bit undetected, really, I'd say.
Too quickly for Derbyshire's liking. Chris Benjamin, 1-4 and 3 sixes. In fact, Hose has got 1-4 and 3 sixes as well. Benjamin, strike rate of 223. Hose on strike now, though, moves away from the stumps and it's smashed down the ground by Hose for four runs. That is a terrific shot. It's a proper cricket shot, really. He did move into the leg side to give himself a little bit of room, but he has hammered that.
I think that's what you've got to do as a batter in T20 cricket as well. They've got all the fielders out on the leg side, so get it over your fielders on the offside and it's a safe shot.
12, that's got to be more than 12, surely. 10, no, 12, 13 runs off the over, in fact. 161 for four, including the wide. 6 of 4 and a couple of singles. There's still two balls of it to go, but Scrimshaw is in and bowls a short delivery. That's a quick short delivery as well. And Hose, I think quite correctly, had nothing to do with it.
Yeah, just keep out of the way of that one. They can get away with a dot ball here. I mean, they're up to 9 and over. They're hitting it nicely, so there's no need to take it on when you don't have to.
But even nines, I think Derbyshire would be happy to chase nines in this day and age. It can be tricky, but they'll give it a go.
They've got the batting for it. Well, if everyone comes off.
Yeah, they've certainly got plenty of batting. They bat a long way down. as George Scrimshaw will be hoping he doesn't have to bat later on this evening, as this one is turned into the leg side, probably off a glove. It's going to be fielded by Hayden Kerr, who's still out there, which is terrific news. And the over comes to an end. Whoa, here we go. 162 for four. Have to happen sooner or later. 14 off that over. Adam Hose has 44. Chris Benjamin has 29. The partnership, 73 off just 34 deliveries. And the run rate is exactly 9 and over. And I just can't even talk over Sweet Caroline. So I'm out as well.
They've turned this straight up, didn't they?
It's gone to 11. Gone to 11. Here's Hayden Kerr. He's not shying away from the hard work. He bowled two overs in the power play, and now he's bowling two at the death. And this one's been hit back towards us. Has it gone over? Oh no, it's bounced onto the top tier of the media centre here.
Thought your car was in danger then, Fletch.
Yes. My car is. The old car would have fallen to bits if a cricket ball would hit it, but this is quite a new one. Hayden Kerr needs to turn round here, or we've got a chase on. Yeah, well done to Brooke Guest.
Umpire checking the ball.
Well, it hit the media centre with quite a thud, didn't it? I think it's fair to say. Even to Shane Dolan, who's listening in Pittsburgh on his, well, he's watching on his phone.
Pittsburgh.
Good for him. Your Pirates are going down this weekend, Shane. That one's guided down towards third man. Nice shot by Hose. He moved on to 50 with the six, and now he's moved up to 54. From 29 deliveries, 172 for four now. With still 10 deliveries left. Derbyshire just got to be careful here not to let this one get away from them. They don't look like they're panicking yet, though, to be fair. Shan Massoud, he's one of the coolest customers I think I've ever seen on a cricket field.
He's just a very calm man. I mean, that's what you need as well from a captain, is someone who doesn't get affected by too much that's happening at once.
Here comes Kerr again, the Australian on debut. That's a good delivery. He cramps a Hose up for a bit of room there, and they're going to come back for an overthrow, are they? No, that's good backing up by Wayne Madsen. There was a shy at the stumps from Lewis Rees, who's at backward point. We'll see him with the bat fairly shortly. I'd be staggered if he didn't open with Shan Massoud. Harry Kane to come in third, Madsen deploy, Guest, McKeon and Kerr. Mark Watt can hit the ball. Not sure whether he'll come in below Sam Connor's mind, but that's what we've got on this team sheet in front of us. I'd be surprised.
Connors might come in and just tee off from ball one.
Might.
You don't know.
No, but you do really. This is the short delivery. Now then, this one's up in the air. Harry Kane is interested momentarily. And the ball, good catch. Good catch in the East Midlands demolition stand. The ball's gone for six. That is a terrific crowd catch, by the way. It was nonchalant, wasn't it?
I'll just take that, have it back. Get him on the field.
Well, the problem is, if he was on the field, he wouldn't have been able to catch it. Because he's in the second row of the East Midlands demolition stand. 179 for four now. Benjamin, 35 from 14 deliveries. A strike rate of 250. In goes Hayden Kerr and bowls. This one smashed down the ground for six. Wayne Madsen has a little jump at long on, but it was always, always going over his head. Just slipping a bit here for Derbyshire.
So they've been bowling tight all game, and they've sort of let it go in the last couple of overs, and the Bears are now sort of picking that run rate back up again.
23 runs off this over with one ball left. Mark Watt bowled a 24 run over.
Benjamin's on 41 off 15.
Well, Shane Dolan's offering me a wager on the Pirates Padres. I'm not sure I've got the confidence. That one's down the leg side. He gets something on it, possibly leg.
And got away with that one.
And he's picked up another single. So at the end of the over, 186 for four. The second, the 24 run over. If my maths was any good, I'd be really dangerous. 48, 58, 68, 72, 75 runs off the last four overs. Yes. And off the last five, I should have just looked at the screen, 81 at 16 runs and over. So the final over of the innings is going to be bowled, good luck, by Sam Connors. It's only his third, 1 for 20 his figures so far. Can he remove one of these two very well set batsmen? The partnership is 97. In comes Connors and Bowles, and that one is crashed up towards long on, and they're dropped. Mark Watt drops a fairly straightforward catch out in the deep. Should have been taken. It went straight to him. That's what he's there for at long on.
It just hit him and bizarre, wasn't it? And hit the floor.
Bizarre. Got to take those. Mark Watt perhaps still thinking about that over number 16 when he went for 24 runs. They've now got two men out on the long on and long off boundary. 187 for four partnership up to 98. Hose on strike. He's got 55. He lifts that out into the leg side. There's going to be a catch here, and it is taken. And Hose has gone 55. He's made Adam Hose. The catch out in the distance from Matty McKiernan. And Sam Connors picks up his second wicket.
It's good from Connors. He dropped first ball, just come straight back at it. Force him to hit over the field as you've got out. And it's worked for him, and he's shown he can do it in this game as well as his red ball at the moment.
Absolutely. 2 for 21, his figures down from 2 overs and 2 balls. He's going to be bowling to Carlos Brathwaite. Remember the name? I think that's his full name now, actually, because whenever you say Carlos Brathwaite, you have to say, remember the name.
Yeah.
You have to say it. He's got a nickname on his back, I noticed.
He said Ricky, didn't he?
Ricky, yeah. I don't know what that's all about.
His bat looks so small in his hat.
He's a big man.
It's just like a toothpick, isn't it?
He is a big man. It's Carlos.
I'm excited to see what Brathwaite does.
We've got four deliveries. I think he had two or one delivery last night. He's not had an awful lot of cricket. He got a first bowler when he played in the Birmingham League earlier this season.
That went viral on Twitter, that did, didn't it?
Yeah. I think he had his car stolen as well on the same day. He's waiting now as Sam Connors comes in and bowls. He goes back into his crease. It's a full toss. It's turned away, and that's four runs out to... backward square leg. You don't bowl there to Carlos Brathwaite. He almost forced him to bowl there. He went a long way back into his crease, Brathwaite, and Connors just lost his line.
He does tend to sit quite deep, and it sort of gives him that little bit more time to just pick up the ball and be able to hit it wherever he wants to. This will be good for Connors, though, because bowling at world-class players just makes you a better player yourself.
That's the theory. Is Connors, little skipper, as he's on his way in. Bolster Brathwaite, who smashes this down the ground. That's huge. That is huge. It's out of the ground. It's over the wall. It's
that's
bouncing away to the Pentagon Island.
That's definitely come off of a roof there, hasn't it?
They're never getting that ball. Well, there's an emergency. I don't think that's related in any way as the ambulance goes past with its lights flashing. That was massive. Out towards long on, the umpires immediately go for the new box of balls. We need a ball that is 19 overs and 4 balls old. It's 197 for 5. Brathwaite has faced two deliveries. He's hit a 4 and a 6.
I'm hoping someone was stood there shouting heads as that went over the wall.
It went a long way over the wall as well. And we've seen some big hits. I remember a few years ago, Andre Russell put one on the from similar kind of position where the pitch is, onto the roof of the members' pavilion and broke a tile. That was quite a big hit. And we've seen them go into the car park, but as a straight delivery, that was massive, absolutely massive.
So Connors just needs to pull this back now. Finish strong.
He's got two deliveries left to bowl. 2 for 31 is figures. He's in and bowls to Brathwaite, who lifts it down the ground again. That's 6 more, I fancy. Or is it going to be caught by Shaun Masood? It's caught by Shaun Masood. And very casually, Sam Connors lifts his left arm. And that's been a very entertaining 3 deliveries from Carlos Brathwaite. He hit a 4, he hit a 6, and then he was caught on the boundary by Masood. And Sam Connors picks up his 3rd wicket.
I think Connors just kept bowling it where he wanted to and almost forced Brathwaite to make a mistake. And he's just not quite got hold of it with that massive bat in his hand.
I was convinced that I'd gone the distance when it left.
It did
his
look
bat.
Like it looked
another
like
big
it from
one,
you.
Didn't it? Looked like another big one, but no.
I've learned over the years to never say anything's a good shot until you know it's gone to the boundary, yes. Because everyone always gets out. I'll be sat there going, "Yes, that's a great shot." Oh, yeah. Stop clapping.
Do that
there.
One village cricket, don't you go, "Oh, shot," and then somebody will pull off a worldy catch. So the new batsman is Henry Brooks, bless him. He's going to face one delivery, Henry Brooks. Benjamin is going to finish on 43, unless something goes wrong for Connors, and that one is down the leg side. They're going to go through for a single. There might be a run out off a wide. No, Connors doesn't take it cleanly, and they pick up two more and move to 199. That's all very, very disappointing, because it means that Benjamin isn't going to finish on 43. Necessarily, he might.
No, he might.
But I don't think he will. You can't get to 50. Absolute chaos out there in the middle. 199 for six. Brooks has faced... Well, he hasn't faced a delivery, of course, because that wasn't a legitimate delivery, but they managed to get two runs from it. Work that one out in the United States, if you can. Good luck.
Lots of changes.
Yes, they've got the man down at final leg.
Everyone is out going on the leg side.
As Connors is in and bowls, and that one is a good delivery. There's a shot at the stumps, it misses. They run through for a bye. And the innings comes to an end at exactly 200. 200 for six. The not out batsman, Chris Benjamin, who finishes on 43. And poor old Henry Brooks doesn't get a single run. And the bowling figures, how many runs off that over? 14 off that last over, so 200 for six. So a couple of wickets, but I'm sure that scoreboard's going to turn off in a moment. I'll tell you what we'll do. They have about a 10-minute break here. So we've just seen a fairly decent innings from Birmingham. Derbyshire are going to need 201 to win. 29 from Paul Sterling and Alex Davis. 43 not out from Chris Benjamin. 55 from Adam Hose. Three wickets for 33 in his three overs for Sam Connors. Matty McKinnon, the most economical, picked up one for 21 from four. One for 31 from four from George Scrimshaw. Mark Watt got rather hammered in his, for it went for 24 runs. Hayden Kerr on his debut, 0 for 55 from four overs. He'll have better days in a Derbyshire shirt as well. We have got around about 10 minutes break, and we will break, but we will return on the BBC Sport website and app and on the Derbyshire live stream in under 10 minutes time. top of the order, hasn't opened the batting this season in the Championship. It's been Billy Godleman and Shan Masood. This evening he opens the batting for the first time since Shan Masood arrived with his new skipper. Tall order, Laurent, the most successful Derbyshire run chase, incidentally 193/7 here in 2014 against a team called Warwickshire. So they're going to have to break a record to get there.
I think if they were ever going to break that record, I think it would be this season with their batting that they've got. I mean, they bat all the way down to Hayden Kerr on our sheet here.
Yeah.
So, like we said, Mark Watt, he can hit a ball if he needs to as well. So, I think it'd be interesting to see how they follow this chase as well.
So he doesn't have to hit a ball, Mark Watt. It's going to be Paul Sterling. He opens the batting, he opens the bowling.
What doesn't he do?
Some cricketer, former Middlesex, Northamptonshire, Ireland international, bowling to Pakistan international Shan Masood, Derbyshire skipper. In comes Sterling and bowls to him, and he just pushes it into the leg side, and there's the first run of the 201 that they require to win this game. Tick them off. Sued off the mark straight away. We've got the DLS par scores on the screen as well. I do like the DLS par scores. They're exactly where they should be. It's not going to rain, incidentally. We're not going to require Duckworth Lewis.
I'd be worried if it rained now.
Yeah. Well, they're right up with the run rate. Is Lewis Rees facing? Ball by this clubbed into the leg side. It's going to be one bounce out to one of the two men out of the 30-yard circle that are allowed. He's at deep backward square leg, so both batsmen up and running. Birmingham scored 9 off the first over, bowled by Hayden Kerr. Birmingham have gone with, I was going to say spin, but I'm not sure how much he turns it. This one is driven up towards long off, who's the other man out. The 30-yard circle.
This is good from Derbyshire to start with as well. Just hitting it round into the gaps, getting themselves in, and then just taking the ones when they're there, and it happens to be 3 off 3.
Yeah, they don't want the scoreboard can't remain static for too long in T20 cricket, can it? Otherwise, you're in a spot of bother. Mickey Arthur just going into the dugout as Rees makes a bit of room for himself, doesn't hit it as well as he would have liked, and gestures that he hasn't done so, but he picks up another single. 4 deliveries gone, 4 without loss. Good start from Birmingham, good start from Paul Sterling, all the experience in the world, Paul Sterling. At the same stage, they've got 8, apparently. Birmingham, this one is, clubbed, rather ugly looking club by Shan Masood down the ground. Once again, fielded by Sam Hain, who's at long off. 5 deliveries gone, a single off each of them.
You can see that both Rees and Masood are trying to give themselves a little bit of space to try and open up some different areas of the ground. It's just not quite working out at the moment, but they are still ticking along nicely.
Pace off the ball as well. It's tricky, isn't it, at the start of an innings. This one is clubbed off an inside edge down towards square leg, and the over comes to an end. 6 from it. 6 without loss, Derbyshire. Chasing 201 to win. Both batsmen, Shan Masood and Lewis Rees, have 3 apiece. So are we going to see bowling from the city end? It looks as though it's Henry Brooks to me. It is Henry Brooks. Great spot, that, by the way. I've seen Henry Brooks before, but I wouldn't know him if he walked past me.
You can see the colours better on the shirts.
I can see the numbers, yeah. I did spot the 0 at the end of his number, so it could only have been him. A gull flies overhead. A lost gull. That'll be Lewis Rees to face the first delivery of the Brooks over. And he has a big swing at that one. He gets an edge, and it's been caught by wicketkeeper Alex Davis. And that isn't the start that Derbyshire were looking for at all. Lewis Rees goes for 3. Derbyshire are 6 for 1.
It's just taking a bit of a dance down the wicket and a wild swing at it. It's just clipped the edge on the way through, unfortunately, for Rees.
Just a little deviation as Davis took the catch, and Brooks picks up a wicket with his first delivery. 6-1 is not where Derbyshire wanted to be, and here comes Harry Kane. Got a half century against Notts on Tuesday in the warm-up game when he opened with Sean Massoud, who's just had a drink brought to him by, I want to say, Mikey Cohen. That's who it looks like to me.
But I think, I know he's just got out, but I think Derbyshire have started off with some nice intent as well. And instead of just letting the ball come onto the bat, they are trying to come at the Bears, which obviously has not worked out this time for Rhys, but I think it's a positive style of cricket, which is what you want to see.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. At the end of the power play, the Bears were up to 54. They scored an awful lot of runs in the final five overs as well, once the set batsman got going. Derbyshire got to make sure they don't lose this game before they try to win it. Harry Kane just flexes his knees as Brooks is in, and that one is down the leg side and wide. He's signalled.
See, now you've got the right hand left hand combo going on, which is going to go, I think, in Derbyshire's favour for the bowlers as well. Throw them off their lines a little bit.
Well, hopefully. There's a bit of an ugly looking swing from Lewis Rees, but these things happen in T20 cricket.
Sometimes you can get a bit ahead of yourself.
Okay, and waits and clips this. That'll be four runs. The first boundary for Derbyshire. He's clipped it nicely off his legs down towards the long leg boundary. And Harry Kane gets the four signalled by Wayne Madsen on the big screen. And he will feel a lot better about life, having picked up his first run. In fact, Wayne Madsen's signalling it twice. 11-1. I don't think he was supposed to. Harry Kane.
I think it's just that straight in the line a little bit. He's bowled to a left-hander first up, and now he's just clipped it away.
Quite a wide run-up, hasn't it? This one's played out to the leg side by Kane, fielded by Jacob Bethel, and there's no run.
Yeah, Brooks is coming in from quite a wide angle.
It is, isn't it?
It's obviously what works for him, and I know that some people do that. Some people like to be really tight to the stumps.
Mm. I do like the... really pains me to say it, but I do like the Birmingham shirts, yellow with blue flashes on them.
It's quite striking.
Yeah, it is. You can see them flying out of the club shop. Here's Brooks in again, and Kane drives out into the offside. That's beaten the man on the edge of the 30-yard circle. There's a chase on. They're coming back for a second. The slide will be put in by Adam Hose, and they think about a third, and Harry Kane is sent back by Sean Massoud quite correctly. So they just pick up two more, but it was a good shot by Harry Kane. There's a little bit of width on offer. He took it.
And that's what you've got to do, especially the T20s. You know that a bowler every now and again will probably stray from their lines, and it's just jumping on that opportunity and even if it's just twos, taking them when they're there.
Can't afford to lose too many wickets. You don't want to lose three wickets in the power play. That's what they say. This one's pulled into the leg side. There's a big chase around the boundary here. For what looks like a substitute fielder, because he's wearing 18 on his back, and I don't have an 18 on my scorecard, I'm afraid.
Do
I?
It's Mills.
Oh, he's at the bottom, it's Craig Mills. Miles, rather. I beg your pardon, I do. He's right at the bottom. That's a good shot by Harry Kane, though. He was raced on to 10 from four deliveries. No pressure on Sean Massoud. That's good. Take the pressure off the skipper. In comes this next delivery, and it's driven, and Kane sets off.
So it's a good hand there.
It was a good hand from the bowler. Brooks. Yeah, and that's the end of the Brooks over. It was a successful over. 11 runs came from it, but a wicket as well. 17-1 after two at the same stage. The Bears were 22 without loss. Who are we going to see now? There we go, Danny Briggs. Good operator in T20 cricket.
Danny Briggs has been around for a while, hasn't he?
And
he just constantly, every time I seem to watch it on the telly, just in the wickets all the time.
Picked up three last night. Jake Lintott picked up three as well. That's a spin. He's going to be bowling to Sean Massoud, left arm around the wicket, balls to Massoud, who clubs this into the way. He's hit that hard, square leg, four runs. Thank you very much indeed, Massoud. Might be up and running as well now. He moves on to 7. Derbyshire up to 23.
That's what you're going to get from Massoud.
21-1.
The class of, he'll just pick up on anything that's too short. It's not quite where the bowler wants it.
Terrific shot from Shan Masood. Briggs bowls to begin and he punches this down the ground. He's hit that hard too, and that's four more. Another really fine shot from Shan Masood, who was the third highest run scorer in the PSL, the latest edition of that, back in his homeland. Described it to me earlier this week as the second best T20 competition in the world behind the IPL. PSL, there's some very good cricketers playing in it. Masood's on 11, Cape has 10, 25 for one. Derbyshire, and for the first time for a long time, they're ahead of Duckworth Lewis. As Briggs is in again and he drives this out, there's a gap there. Can he find the gap? No, he can't. They'll just take a single as it's fielded by Craig Miles. And Shan Masood is suggesting to Harry Kane there was two there. And it is something again that he spoke about, the number of boundaries that you get. It's what you do with the other deliveries, whether you get ones and twos, and if you can turn the ones into twos and the twos into threes, because this is such a huge playing area.
Yeah, I think that sort of makes a difference. Like, you can hit the ball as hard as you want over the boundary, but if you're dotting it up or only taking singles because you're a bit lazy running here and there, yeah, other teams are just going to take up on that.
Briggs around the wicket bowls to Kane, who drives out into the offside. It's beaten the man at backward point and raced away to the boundary for four more. Kane moves to 14 from six. Derbyshire are 30 for one now in the third over, and everybody's feeling slightly happier.
This is a good start for Derbyshire. They're making the Bears bowlers think a little bit about where the fields are, where they're bowling, anything just slightly off, and they seem to be punishing it at the moment.
Carlos Brathwaite, the skipper, just spoken to Danny Briggs. Barely took his hands out of his pockets. Briggs bowls. That one is pushed out into the offside. They're going to go through for a quick single. That's excellent. Excellent running by Shan Masood. Called Harry Kane through. Masood was well on his way. And Derbyshire moved to 31 for one. Harry Kane up to 15 from seven. So his strike rate is in excess of 230. Shan Masood's strike rate at the moment and a very even 200. This one, driven straight to Carlos Brathwaite and he's gone. Brathwaite throws the ball in the air. Masood has gone. Very, very simple catch for Carlos Brathwaite, and that is a major blow for Derbyshire. Masood goes for 12, and Derbyshire are 31 for two now.
Just looked like he was trying to do a little bit too much there. They were going along nicely, and I don't think he needed to try and clear the mountain that is Brathwaite.
He's a big man to get over, isn't he? He's a big man to get over. And out comes Lewis Deploy. We weren't sure whether it would be Lewis Deploy or Wayne Madsen, but they like to keep Wayne Madsen for the overs outside the power play. Derbyshire's batting is going to be tested here. Such a straightforward catch. It was the end of the over as well, wasn't it? So 31.
Yeah.
For two.
It looks like Brathwaite is going to be coming on to bowl.
I remember the name. Carlos Brathwaite will bowl over number four. At the same stage, the Bears were 32 but without loss. Derbyshire are 31 for two and can't really afford to lose another wicket in the power play. The power play for Birmingham was 54, had a couple of lean overs. Overs four and five. Harry Kane is going to be facing Carlos Brathwaite. Tapping his bat in the crease. Here comes Brathwaite from the city and then bowls to Harry Kane, who whips this away down the leg side. Off a bit of bat. Down to fine leg for four runs. And that is another boundary for Kane. It's his fourth. Sorry, Laura.
Just straying the line again. Kane is good enough to just pick up on it every time, and that's all he's had to do this innings so far, is just pick up on those slightly different bad balls. 19 off 8.
Yeah, strike rate 237 for Harry Kane. Derbyshire 35 for 2. Here's Brathwaite again, bowls. That's a better delivery, and it's clipped up towards mid-on, the wide mid-on. It's fielded by a sprawling fielder out there in the distance, who I think is Henry Brooks. And get through for another single. Kane moves to 20. 20 from nine deliveries. Keep an eye on the clock. Update down to the 9 o'clock news. Miles away. Probably 10 minutes till the next update. This game will be, we'll know which direction it's going pretty much.
Yeah, it moves very quickly, does T20 cricket. Got some rowdy members of the crowd starting as well.
There's a surprise. 5 to 9 in the evening. Oh, Lias de Ploy has smashed Carlos Brathwaite back over his head. It's not even going to get to the boundary for 4. He's going to pick up 2 runs for it. He's got to be careful here, Lias de Ploy. With a short delivery, he smashed it straight back down the ground, but with a sort of horizontal bat. Not the kind of shot you necessarily want to see.
Almost a bit like tennis.
I thought he'd got hold of it there as well.
Well,
I did initially, and then I thought, oh no, he hasn't got any of it.
I thought, I'm not going to say anything until I know what he's done.
38 for 2. Brathwaite in and bowls to deploy you. Tries to work this into the leg side. It drops at his feet. Brathwaite does the fielding. 38 for 2. They were 40 for 1 at the end of the fourth over Birmingham. So not much between the sides at this stage.
It's just Derbyshire need to keep those wickets under control and not get too ahead of themselves.
The bar doing a roaring trade away to our left-hand side as Brathwaite comes in and bowls to deploy. He just guides this very nicely down towards third man. It beats Sterling. Kame's coming back for the second and he gets... deploy, rather, coming back for the second and gets there very comfortably indeed. Doubles his score. He moves on to 4. Derbyshire to 40 for 2. Paul Sterling fielding at third man. If he goes straight to him, he'll be fine. Otherwise, as he claps his hands, might be in a spot of bother. Brathwaite, final ball of his first over. 9 runs off it so far. Bowling to Lias de Ploy, goes into the offside and then guides it into the offside as he steps back into the leg side. There's a semi-shy at the stumps. It's the end of the over. I didn't describe that massively well, I've got to say. 41 for 2 at the end of the over. Brathwaite conceding 10 off that over. 41 for 2 at the same stage. Birmingham are 40 for 1. So nothing between the sides. Douglas Lewis Power score is 44, so Derbyshire not too far behind that. And of course it changes when you lose wickets. Henry Brooks is changing ends here. He bowled the second over, it went for 11. He's going to bowl the fifth. 2 more overs of power play. There was some fairly fierce hitting though, let's not forget, in the final 5 overs.
Yeah, I think if Derbyshire can just sort of tick along and then wait for their moment to sort of really strike, then they'll be well in this game.
89 in the last 5. Now that Harry Kane has just lifted that.
That's deploy.
Oh, it's deploy. I beg your pardon. It is deploy. Good job somebody's watching. Deploy lifts. That was a bizarre shot.
It was a very dangerous shot. I mean, if he's missed that, that's straight into his middle stump.
Stumps everywhere.
But that's what Deploy does. He likes to be a bit innovative with his shots and stuff like that. So, fair play.
I'm going to watch this next delivery. It's definitely Deploy and it's Brooks bowling to him. He's done it again and this time he fiddles it out into the offside.
It's a bit of French cricket.
It's fielded by the man at point. Deploy moves on to 10. 46 for 2. Too early in the competition to get too nervous. And what I've seen so far, I've not been entirely unimpressed with from a Derbyshire perspective. I'm sure that Hayden Kerr will have benefited from his first run out for Derbyshire.
He's only going to get more settled as well.
He's had one net session with them. Yeah. That's it, since he arrived from India. Brooks bowls, and this is straight up in the air. Is it going to be a catch? No, it's gone over the field. Are they going to come back for a second as well? It was fielded down below us. In the end, by Sam Hain, and he's got away with one there. Harry Kane, he didn't get that at all well, but he moves on to 22, 48 for 2.
There's a couple from the Derbyshire lads today that have just sort of gone straight up, but they've got away with a couple of them. So I think they just need to be a bit careful.
We've still got an over and a half of power play as Brooks is in, and this Harry Kane tries the ramp shot, misses it completely. And it goes through to wicketkeeper Alex Davis. Never looks good when you don't connect, does it, the ramp shot? It makes you look like you're trying to get out of the way, or I don't know, it just looks horrible.
Yeah, it's one of those shots where if it comes off, everyone loves it, but then it just looks odd, doesn't it?
He didn't make any contact with it at all, so his strike rate is down to 200 now. 22 from 11, Brooks bowls, and then he's tried a ramp shot, and he's got the toe end on that, and it's gone out into mid-wicket.
Some interesting shots from Kame and Deploy going on here.
Well, they're keeping us on our toes, because the ball could go anywhere at any stage. I should have been able to spot that it was Deploy, because he's left-handed, of course.
Yeah. That's why I thought I got a bit confused when you said Kame. I was like, I thought Kame was right-handed.
I have no idea what I'm doing. People will know who listen to me regularly. I can mistake anybody for anybody at any moment. They've sent the fine leg out to the boundary, so they've had to bring the backward point into the 30-yard circle as Brooks is in around a wicket, bowls to Deploy, smashes it down the ground for six. That's a terrific blow from Lias Deploy. He's a dangerous batsman, as you said, Lauren. He moves on to 16. That was a terrific blow, and the 50s up for Derbyshire. They're 55 for two at the end of the over, 14 off that one. Same stage.
And if that scoreboard's right, they are ahead on the DLS par scores.
Yeah, they're actually ahead for the first time as well. They still trail by 145, though. The current run rate is 11. The required rate is 9.7. And we're going to see Craig Miles for the first time this evening. He didn't bat. He's the number 11 batsman. Jake Lintott will be warming up, I'm sure, somewhere with his variety of spin.
Yeah, Miles took 15 wickets last year.
Decent operator. He's in from the city end and bowls to Kame, who smashes it straight into the hands of mid-off, and he's gone. Didn't get hold of that one at all, I'm afraid, Harry Kame. It was a fairly straightforward catch. He did have to go low down, but Harry Kame goes for 23. And I'm afraid that Derbyshire are now 55 for three with five balls left of the power play. He walks off looking at the toe end of his bat. It was a nice little knock, but no more than a cameo really from Harry Kame. And now we will see the two South African born batsmen, Wayne Madsen and Lias Deploy, together. Jacob Bethel with the catch. A little disappointing.
Wayne Madsen. He was going along nicely, Kame was, so to see him get out like that. I mean, he's played a few that sort of gone up and not really gone anywhere, but that one he sort of got hold of even less than before.
A couple of minutes before we update listeners on AFM. We're currently enjoying Bearded Theory with Martin Williams over on BBC Radio Derby. Wayne Madsen on strike to the second delivery of the Craig Miles. But look what it's done to Duckworth Lewis. They're behind again now. Disappointing. Not that it's going to rain.
For a ball, yeah.
Yeah, just the one. So, Craig Miles, one delivery, one wicket. That won't carry on, of course. He's on his way in from the city end of ball to Wayne Madsen, who gets one that lifts on him a little bit. Turned down to fine leg when it's fielded by Sterling, and he goes through for a single, so he's off the mark. 56 for three. Miles starting this season as he went through most of last season with those wickets. A lot on the shoulders of these two batsmen. There's Brooke Guest to come, Matty McKinnon and Hayden Kerr.
I think there's batting left, but I think you just don't want to leave it down to those lower order batters. So if Deploy and Madsen can stay in,
they've
and tick
along.
They've
sort of got to get them close, haven't they?
Yeah.
Mm. Here is Miles in and bowls. That's turned into the leg side by Lias Deploy. He moves on to 17 from 8 deliveries, 57 for 3. They still need a further 143 to win. And this is Dave Fletcher at the Incora County Ground watching Derbyshire's opening game of the T20 Blast. They're chasing 201 to beat the Birmingham Bears, and they've already lost three wickets inside the power play. Lewis Reeks for three, Shan Masood for 12, and most recently Harry Kane for 23. It's all down, you would think now, to Wayne Madsen, who's just about getting his innings underway. He's got one. And Lias Deploy, who's on 17. Derbyshire, 57 for three. They need another 144 to win. There was a short delivery there to Wayne Madsen that he went to hook and
yeah,
missed.
They did go up. Thought he might have got a little something on it, but I didn't hear anything, and obviously the umpire didn't hear anything either, so got away with that one.
He's a walker, Madsen. He's a walker. It's at Miles Bowles. That was crashed out into the offside. That'll be four runs. One, two, three bounces into the boundary rope. And Madsen picks up his first boundary. He moves on to five.
There you go. And he's signalling himself.
Yes. But no smile. Very serious look on Wayne Madsen's face as he signals the four run. Though he's done it again, just for good measure. 61 for three. Oh, Jane's going to tell us something, but I'm not sure what it is, and I don't want to disrupt her. She's going to tell us something here. Jane, the scorer. She's in. Here comes Miles again.
Should have been Hose, not Bethel.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
Thank you. In comes Miles and Bowles, and that one's lifted again over the 30-yard circle. There's a man down at backward point, so Madsen picks up a single. Not Bethel taking the catch to dismiss Harry Kane. It was Adam Hose. That's the end of the power play. 62-3. So that means there were seven runs off that Craig Miles over. At the same stage, Birmingham are 54-1. It's those three wickets that are the problem, I'm afraid. There's Jake Lintott. I like Jake Lintott's hairstyle.
Is there any reason for that?
I've got to say that is a proper haircut that Jake Lintott's got out there. He's had every single hair on his head removed. And looking at him, he doesn't look like he's actually going bald. I think this is a career, this is a life choice.
Mine's gone for it.
Mine, not so much. 62 for three then. Wayne Madsen, six. Lias Deploy, 17. Madsen on strike. The left arm spinner is in, and he's pulled into the leg side by Wayne Madsen for a single. These two are going to have to do an awful lot of running, you fancy, in the coming overs. 63-3.
Yeah, last year, Lintott took 15 wickets as well.
Everybody who's bowling has taken 15 wickets.
They've all taken 15.
What's going on?
Well, Brathwaite took 18.
18? Oh, dear. He hasn't got one yet tonight. Brooks, Briggs and Miles with the wickets. Lintott loses his run-up. It's only about 10 steps. It's quite long for a left-arm spinner. Not 10 steps at all, he bowls, and that one is pushed out into the offside by Lias Deploy. They run the first one quickly, and they're going to come back for they're not going to come back for the second for the misfield.
He's juggled it well.
Almost dropped it to the ground, Chris Benjamin, but it managed to hold on to it despite the juggle. 64 for three now. Too far away from DLS. The run rate is 10, the required rate is 10. As Lintott is in and bowls to Madsen, who defends this delivery. Ball that comes off the bat doesn't even reach Lintott. He has to walk forward to pick it up, remarkably.
That's it. My bowlers aren't picking that up. They'll just stare at it and wait for somebody else to pick it up.
That's lazy. There's nobody within 30 yards of him. He's in and bowls a full toss to Madsen, who sweeps violently out towards the mid-wicket boundary. There's a good sliding stop out there, and they're going to come back for a second, but Hose did well. They're sliding around the boundary and got the throw away as well. Two more to Madsen, though. 66 for three.
Yeah, Madsen's a good sweeper of the ball. Anytime he gets down to sweep it, you just back him to...
Doesn't mind a reverse either.
No?
Doesn't mind a reverse. There are two men waiting for it, and here is the reverse, and he's lifted it over those two men and got four runs for it. There we go.
He spoke that into existence, has he?
He doesn't mind. Well, I've seen him do it in first-class cricket as well, Wayne Madsen, but in T20. He's a 360 degree batsman, as they say.
Yeah. I think it just adds that little extra layer, doesn't it, that a bowler's got to think about, right, this batter, they can play it wherever they want, what am I going to do? So that's what Madsen does.
8 runs off the over so far, 70 for 3, last ball of it. In top bowls, Madsen. Oh, it's in the air now, then. Oh, it's going to fall safe just inside the 30-yard circle. They're going to come back for 2. That's remarkable. Madsen moves on to 15. 72 for 3 at the end of the over. 10 off that, which is exactly what they require. And, Wayne Madsen gets away with one there, but it just went straight up in the air and plugged, really. Scatter blast. That's exciting. They're going to be firing T-shirts at small children fairly shortly. I think it's William who's got the scatter blast thing out there.
Yeah, there's been lots of people queuing up for the throwing challenge going on behind the family stand.
Excellent.
As well.
Excellent. I'll have a go at that some
point. We've got Tom, Jess and Laura there from the foundation.
Excellent.
Jess and Laura play for the senior women's team.
Do they?
Jess bowler, Laura good batter, best sweeper in the pathway, we call her.
Well, my Madsen's out there, he'd enjoy that. Oh, played straight back to the bowler and it falls just short. It's a new over from Danny Briggs. That was almost a caught and bowl off the first ball. Just seemed to hold up in the pitch. I'm not sure that it did.
He's just sort of pushing at it a little bit.
Briggs again bowls, and this time he's down the track, meets it as it bounces on the half volley as Lear's deploy picks up a single. He moves on to 19, 73 for 3. Field changes for the right-handed Wayne Madsen. Everybody moves around
Everybody
one, it seems.
Is charging around the pitch.
Lights taking effect here at the Incora County Ground. 9:10 on a Friday night. Where else would you rather be? Briggs bowls. Madsen just turns it into the leg side for a single. They do think about two, but Briggs has raced out there to pick the ball up and make sure that they can only take a single.
Is it the commitment to fielding off your own bowling? That's what you need when you've got everybody out. It's your figures you've got to look after.
Absolutely. 1 for 16 from 9 deliveries. Danny Briggs at the moment. 74 for 3. In he comes, and that's turned into the leg side by Lear's deploy. That's nicely placed. He's going to come back for a second really comfortably here. Pushes it just over the 30-yard circle. Briggs went for it. It was chased by Jacob Bethel as well. But in the end, it was picked up. I'm looking down on my score sheet. Was that 77 who picked that up?
I think so.
Well, there isn't one on my... There isn't one on mine. Is there? I couldn't see the 18 before, but there isn't a 77. Next delivery is turned into the leg side again by Lear's deploy. This time they are going to stick to a singlers. It is 77. He's a substitute fielder. Who's he on for? Can't tell. No idea. 77 is the score as well. 77 for 3. And Wayne Madsen's number 2. So there's a bit of a theme developing. I have no idea who the 77 for Birmingham is. This one is pulled around very fine by Wayne Madsen to find leg for 4 more. Initially, it looked like it might go straight to...
To Sterling,
but it was to his right. The over comes to an end. And another good over for Derbyshire. 81 for 3 at the end of it. 9 off that at the same stage. But Birmingham was 61 for 2. Derbyshire ahead in terms of runs as Lear's deploy rather fantastically removes his helmet to show the pale blue Derbyshire bandana that he wears. Removes his sweater, takes a drink from Anuj Dal.
Here we go, 77's just gone off.
Has he? Good. Because we don't know who he is.
It's Lintott that came back on.
Right.
There we go.
Went off for a comfort break. He's going to bowl again. He bowled the previous over from the race course end for 10 runs. Apologies to the Birmingham supporters who may be viewing the Derbyshire stream, but we don't get a list of all the players. I'm trying to identify the players as best we can. There will come a time when you'll have a choice, I'm sure, of commentary. Whether you want to go home or away. Here's Jake Lintott then. In bowls. It's a full toss. Oh, it's been smacked down the ground. It's gone straight to the fielder. And Lear's deploy. Well, he might as well have kept his sweater on. It's been caught out of the deep by Jacob Bethel. And Derbyshire have lost their fourth wicket. They're 81 for four. Lear's deploy goes for 22.
Yeah, I thought he might have got hold of that one. It sounded nice off the bat, but he just straight down long arms throat. Not what Derbyshire needs.
No, that is a big, big blow for Derbyshire. It's a huge positive blow for Birmingham Bears. Because they're four down now, Derbyshire haven't reached the halfway stage yet, but in the ninth over, they seem to have lost wickets on the first ball of an over two or three times now. That is not great. In fact, Lear's deploy is still not got beyond the boundary rope. Brookhast has already taken his guard, and Lear's deploy is only just crossing the boundary rope now. Such is his disappointment, wasn't it?
That was.
I mean, I think I'd be quicker. He's thrown his bat on the ground. His gloves are coming off as well. Where are they going?
He's put them down quite nicely.
He's only had one pair of gloves. He's probably got a few bats. Removes his inners. Sits on the bench. Not a happy man. Lintott in and bowled to the new batsman, Brooke Guest, who defends it back to the bowler.
That's charging down the wicket there.
It wasn't a run, was it? Lintott is walking back to his mark, backwards. Didn't take his eyes off Brooke Guest once. Guest waits and pushes this out into the offside, but it's straight to Brathwaite, who's fielding at extra cover. 10 yards or so, perhaps a little bit less inside the circle.
A couple of fielders moving around.
Yeah,
as well.
Short third man at backward point as well. There's cover out on either side. This one is turning to the leg side by Brooke Guest. These two are very quick between the wickets. They're going to come back for the second as well. The ball is on its way in, but Guest gets there comfortably enough in the end as Chris Benjamin throws the ball in. Good running, 83 for four.
Yeah, Derbyshire have been quite good at running today. They've been trying to push those, turn those ones into twos like we were talking about earlier.
Long, long way to go though. 117 more runs for parity. That one's down the leg side. That'll be a wide. It's already been signalled a wide by umpire Neil Pratt. So another run to the total. 84 for four. It's a new headset that I've got here, and I keep banging it, and I apologise for everybody at home. 84 for four. Next delivery is outside the off stump and driven very pleasantly by Brooke Guest. They've run one. They're going to come back for the second. That's a very good second run as well. It was picked up in the deep by Sam Hain.
Yeah, they're running that first one quick, which is what you need to do, and then that second one's a lot easier after that.
86 for four. The run rate's still up around 10, and that is what the required rate is from here. And top bowls. They can't afford to lose any more wickets, though. Clipped into the leg side by Guest, out towards mid-wicket. They go through for a single as Hose does the fielding. It's the end of the over. Just six off that, and a wicket, though. That's a good over from Jake Lintott. 87 for four, Derbyshire. Guest has five, Madsen has 20 at the same stage. There were 65 for two, Birmingham Bears. So it's the loss of fewer wickets that is certainly working in the visitors' favour here. It's always going to be a tough opening game. We chatted prior to the start about whether having played a game might benefit Birmingham. Well, at the moment it's looking like it possibly has. Danny Briggs to continue, left arm around the wicket, balls to Brooke Guest, who gets it off the toe end of his bat, but virtually goes nowhere, but they managed to pick up a single.
Sometimes those sort of shots are all you need to do, because it's just in that massive gap in the leg side, and it's one there every day.
Closest person to it was a square leg umpire. He's got nobody for company. Briggs bowls, it's a driven, straight into the hands of Carlos Brathwaite, and Madsen's gone. He's on his knees, he bows his head, Madsen has gone, and that, ladies and gentlemen, might be that as far as Derbyshire's hopes are concerned. Madsen dismissed, they're 88 for five now.
Yeah, it looked like he was just trying to force a boundary to come out of somewhere, and he's just picked out Brathwaite. He's just nice and easy, put his arms up in the air and just taking it above his head.
Initially, I thought he'd taken it one handed. Hayden Kerr comes out to join Brooke Guest. There's two players with little overall T20 experience, but Hayden Kerr's playing in the Big Bash. Brooke Guest has had a terrific season so far, but they've lost three wickets in the power play and two in successive overs here. It's a very tall order for Derbyshire to win from this position. Birmingham, foot to the throat.
I think if Derbyshire can just tick along and keep those runs coming in with these two in, then I think it's not out of sight just yet.
I'm loving the enthusiasm. Briggs in and bowls. Kerr turns it into the leg side. They'll pick up one. I think they will settle for one. Yes, they will. For Kerr is off the mark. Didn't have the night with the ball that he was hoping for. Wicketless in his four overs.
Yeah, it must have just been cramped with the hamstring because yes. He seemed to run that one.
Yeah, that is good news. Watching him stretching out his leg was not great. Guest drives this one straight back to Danny Briggs, one straight back to him. He has to put in the dive away to his right-hand side to make sure that the ball didn't get past him.
Yeah, it's a good stop off of his own bowling.
Very good stop. He's in again, balls to Guest, who takes two steps down the track and then pushes it out to Carlos Brathwaite. There's no run. Again, really good bowling this from Danny Briggs, who is a terrific operator in T20 cricket. There's no question about it. He's in again, and that one is a full delivery that Guest can do nothing with. The over ends with three dot balls, just two runs off it. 89 for 5 now, Derbyshire. That is the equal best over we've seen in the game this evening. George Scrimshaw bowled a two-run over in the Derbyshire bowling innings, and now Danny Briggs has bowled one as well. Halfway, 89 for 5. They need a further 112 to win.
And Brathwaite is coming back on to have
the
ball.
Oh dear. Well, his first over went for 10. Only two wickets down when he came on the first time. Carlos Brathwaite. Derbyshire now 5 down. Hayden Kerr. So an all international contest here. West Indies against Australia. Carlos Brathwaite. Big man in and bowls, and it's pulled into the leg side by Hayden Kerr. He's not going to get a boundary, but it will come back for a second. The fielder out there in the distance falls over Jacob Bethel, but he still manages to get back to his feet and get the throw away. Derbyshire moved to 91 for 5.
Not quite sure what he did there.
No, it just looked like his feet got caught in the ground and he just fell forward. Very strange.
At least the ball didn't go over the boundary for them.
Yeah, a bit of a shame from a Derbyshire perspective. Kerr's back on strike and guides this to the man at short third man. Immediately raises his bat, tells Brooke Guest there's no run. Of course, the other thing is that Hayden Kerr will never have batted with anybody.
No.
So he doesn't know their little ticks and...
I think you find that as well with... I know we found it this year in terms of you've got new people batting together who've not done it before, and it takes you a little bit of time to get used to that.
Here comes Brathwaite, bowls to Kerr, almost plays on, bounces it into the ground, lands about a yard in front of him. And there is no run, 91 for 5. So a 2 and 2 dot balls to begin the over from Carlos Brathwaite. He's already taken a couple of catches this evening, hit a big 6. Oh, and there's a play and a miss at that one from Hayden Kerr. Brathwaite thought he might have just got a tickle on it, but nobody else went up, so Brathwaite puts his arm down quickly, turns and walks back to his mark. 91 for 5 it remains, and the run rate and the required run rate are getting further apart now. The run rate is 8.5, the required rate is almost 12, which in itself isn't out of hand.
No, and I think if... Derbyshire just need to be careful with the wickets column, I think, at this point. The runs will come because they always do, and there's always singles all over the place. It's just making sure that they don't leave themselves with nobody to get them.
Man's gone out onto the mid-wicket boundary, and that one's turned into the mid-wicket area. They're going to pick up a couple of runs here, I fancy. No, they're not. They're going to get just one. That's a good piece of fielding. Racing in off the boundary was Chris Benjamin. Kerr moves on to four. 92 for five. The cry of you Bears.
Can't. There are a few Bears supporters in today.
No, fair play. Fair play. Not too far on a Friday night. This next one is pulled into the leg side by Brooke Guest. Again, it's Benjamin who does the fielding. And again, it's just a single take. And 93 for five at the end of the over. So in the last three overs, Derbyshire have managed 12 runs and have lost two wickets. Very, very damaging little spell for the home side, which has put the visitors on top. It never stops, does it? It's Jake Linton.
It's coming back.
As soon as you look down, somebody else is getting ready to bowl. And we haven't even had that dreadful song yet. Beautiful sunset.
There's still plenty of time for it to
still plenty
to make
of time
its
for some
out.
Lots of terrible songs.
I'm sure Tom Skinner's got it ready on his playlist.
Yeah. They'll be looking up to see where we are. Next over begins Lintott from the city end. First time he's bowled from the city end, I think. And they get away. Well, they get a single off the first ball. It is. It's the first even numbered over he's bowled.
I think it's flexibility of bowlers now as well to be willing to bowl from whatever end as well. I know that there's times where some people are like, oh, I only want to bowl from this end. And I think being able to bowl from wherever.
As Lintott is in, and that's cut by Hayden Kerr and missed by the man at backward point, so they're going to go through for a second run. They might think about a third as well, but there is no third run available, and they do.
Yeah, being able to bowl from whichever end is really helpful to a captain as well, because it gives them a lot more options. So Brathwaite will be happy about that.
And top in again, bowls to Kerr, who pulls it into the leg side, straight to the fielder out there in the deep though, so again, just the one run. But Hayden Kerr removes to 797 for five.
Yeah, I think this is okay from a Derbyshire perspective. They're just taking a bit more control of the game.
Again, lots of space in the leg side. As Lintott bowls, a reverse sweep comes out from Brooke Guest. I'm not sure I've ever seen him reverse sweep. And he picks up a single.
I think he's just worn that. Yeah, I think it did.
It did hit him at some point. It came off the bat and then hit him. As a result, Derbyshire moved to 98 for five. This next delivery is wide of the off stump, and Kerr tries to cut it away, but gets nothing on it. The ball bounces into the ground. 98 for five, it remains. They were 87 for three at the end of the 12th over. Birmingham, so Derbyshire again, still ahead, but those last five overs, 89 runs scored. This next delivery is pushed up to long on by Kerr. And they're going to come back for a second. Oh, no, they're in all sorts of trouble here. And both batsmen end up at the same end. And Kerr gives himself up. Brooke Guest raced back for the second. Kerr was in, well, he was in, he was adamant there was no second. And he's been run out.
I think that's where the inexperience of batting together has come in. Like, somebody else might have been in and Guest is still charged down, but they've known that that's what he's going to do, whereas Kerr is, as we've said, he's had one net session with them all before today, so he's not aware that that's how Guest is going to be running.
Yeah, you can watch as many videos on the aeroplane on your way over of first class matches, but I'm afraid he's perished as Hayden Kerr for seven. Struggling to find the victim for the post-match interview here. It might have to be the skipper. 98 for five. For six. Hasn't gone on yet, has it, the run out? 98 for six. That's at the end of the over from Jake Lintott. They haven't got the 5 runs off that one. Well, 99 for six has gone up to now, so they'll get one of the runs. Potentially. I don't really know how that works. Kerr's moved on to eight, so we'll have to just wait and see what's happening. They're just doing some adjustments next door. Kerr did get eight.
My Wiles is coming into bowl.
Craig Wiles bowls, and that one's turned into the leg side by Brooke Guest for a single. He moves on to 10. The 100 may or may not be up for Derbyshire. There's a sprinkling of applause. It isn't. Well, no, it isn't. No, it isn't. No, it isn't. Because Guest, oh, he might be. I don't know. I don't know. Something's happening.
Trying to look at Jane through the window.
Yeah. Jane's looking down at the bit of paper. The 100 is up, 100 for 6. And that one is over. A play and a miss from Matty McKinnon. Outside the Ostrom, kept a bit low. Miles is a good operator. There we go, it's all sorted now. Guest has 10. McKinnon yet to get off the mark. Derbyshire are halfway, just about, to the target. But the required rate is up to 13 and the run rate now is 8. So it's a bit of a mess, I'm afraid.
I think Sterling is coming in to slip.
Good grief.
Like a wider.
Yeah, almost a second slip, isn't it, Paul yeah. Sterling? Kieran waits and plays this.
played it really nicely,
but yeah, fielded a backward point. Again, the fielder taking that one on the body, Danny Briggs. But you'll do anything to stop runs in T20, and you've got to.
That's it. You've got to put your body on the line. This is what we keep telling everybody in the modern day of cricket. Always stop the ball however you can. Preferably not with your feet, though.
No, it does look a bit village, doesn't it? 100 for 6. Miles is in. Oh, there's a swing and a miss from Matty McKinnon. He's coming ahead of Sam Connors, Mark Watt and George Scrimshaw. There isn't an awful lot of batting left for Derbyshire now. McKinnon, who has got a first-class century this season, of course. That was at Grace Road.
Here we go. The Bears have decided that they're not going to have a slip in. I might have been tempted to keep the slip in if McKinnon's slashing at the ball like he is.
What will he do with this next delivery from Craig Miles, who's conceded just one run so far? He's in and bowled, and that one is played straight back to him by Matty McKinnon. So four successive dot balls. And the Derbyshire chase has rather stalled. I think I'd be fairly safe in saying that when I do my update in 2 or 3 minutes' time, that this game has gone 100 for 6. In goes Craig Miles once again from the race course end. Bowling to Matty McKinnon, who's got some runs this time, and he's got four of them. He has hit it well. Out to extra cover. Once it has beaten Paul Sterling, who's in fairly close inside the 30-yard circle, who's always going to race away. And Derbyshire move on to 104 for 6 with McKinnon off the mark without boundary. It's the end of the over. 6 runs off it. By Craig Miles.
Yeah, I think Derbyshire have got a long way to go from here. Still trailing by 96.
And they're 12 runs in front. They were 92 for 4 after 13 overs. It shows you the difference in the depth of batting, really. Derbyshire's batting is quite top heavy. Reece, Massoud, Kane, Madsen, Deploy and Guest. A lot rests on Guest's shoulders. He's on 10. He pushes this one out into the offside for a single. They move to 105 for 6. Update coming up in around about 90 seconds. I say roundabout.
That's very specific.
But it was too specific to say roundabout, wasn't it, really? Yeah, I was told around 33 minutes past. Or 27 minutes too. That one is played nicely by Matty McKinnon into the leg side. They've run the first one. This time, they decide against going for the second. There's a slight misfield from Sam Hayden.
Definitely more of a run there than there was for Lewis to run out.
Yes. Yeah, poor old Hayden Kerr. He hasn't had the greatest of nights, has he?
No, but he's got plenty of time to settle.
Oh, I'll say. His next delivery is turned into the leg side by Brooke Guest. They've run the first one quickly. There is only a single, 107 for 6. Guest moves on to 12. Yep, 13 more group games, a game against India as well, here at the County Ground in July. Next delivery is turned up towards long on again by Matty McKinnon, but they'll be more than happy to give them singles. Where are the big hits going to come from for Derbyshire?
I think Derbyshire just don't need to get too ahead of themselves just yet.
This next delivery is played inside out by Brooke Guest out into the offside. And another single is taken, 109 for six.
I say that, but the run rate's got up to 14.9 for the required.
Update coming up shortly as McKinnon tries to whip this one into the leg side. It comes off his pad and goes out into the offside. End of the Briggs over. 110 for six, just six runs off that over. They just can't quite find the big overs here, Derbyshire, and they are slipping, as I will tell Martin very shortly, to defeat. And we're going to see the return of Craig Miles.
Are you an
Abba fan? Well, I'm afraid the atmosphere has pretty much been punctured here, Martin. Derbyshire, 110 for six in pursuit of 201 to win. We're already into the 15th over as well. The loss of wickets has been fairly steady. The latest of them, Hayden Kerr, the Australian, bless him, he bowled four overs, didn't pick up a wicket, and he was run out for seven runs. He only arrived in the country a couple of days ago. Matty McKinnon's just struck a boundary, so a bit of defiance from the Derbyshire batsman. Brooke Guest has 13, but Derbyshire are going to lose this game, I'm afraid. Their opening game in the T20 Blast, they have moved on to 114 for six. They still need 87 to win. So there we are. Update done, and we've just seen the...
the only
aggressive shot we've seen for ages from Matty McKinnon.
It's typical,
yeah, drove it to the extra cover boundary off Craig Miles. Miles is in again and bowls, and he's driven this down the ground, but straight to Carlos Brathwaite, who decides to have a shot at the stumps. It misses, but there are fielders backing up. McKinnon moves to 11, 115 for six. The other games in the North Group will be coming to an end, I would have thought, by now. So we might have some results if I turn this on. We have got some results. Wow. How about this at Old Trafford? Lancashire 183 for seven. Yorkshire 183 for five. Match tied. A tie in the Roses match. Derbyshire play Lancashire on Wednesday after playing Yorkshire on Tuesday next week. In comes Miles again and bowls. That was clubbed into the leg side. Beyond the fielder. Has that gone all the way for six? I think it might have done, you know. The umpires are just consulting. Nobody's quite sure at the moment, and they're going to signal
straight
four
into the bar as well.
One bounce. It bounced very close to the boundary's edge from Harry Kane. That's Harry Kane. From Brooke Guest. That was a really nice shot. Guest moves on to 17. Derbyshire 119 for six. Durham 192 for nine, have lost by 31 runs to Northamptonshire. Nottinghamshire have beaten Worcestershire by four wickets with two balls to spare at Trent Bridge, as Miles is in again, and this one is a play and a miss. There's a half-hearted appeal from behind the wicket, but nothing from the bowler, which rather suggests that it didn't actually touch the bat on the way through. So yeah, four wickets with two balls remaining. Victory for Nottinghamshire. And elsewhere in the Southern Group, Essex have, they need 34 more runs from 21 balls to beat Kent at Canterbury. Surrey have beaten Glamorgan by four wickets. And these adverts on this page make it jump around all over the place. Here comes Miles again, balls, and that's a big hit down the ground. That's going to be six this time. Oh, and the fielder makes a terrific effort to try and catch it. And the crowd catch. After the ball was parried initially by Adam Hose down below, as well caught in the crowd by that lady.
She was chuffed with that.
Wasn't she? Well, she should be. She should be. The other game, Hampshire need 38 from 22 to beat Middlesex. So we bang up to date with the scores elsewhere. Here.
This is the type of over Derbyshire needed.
Brooke Guest has moved on to 23.
Not to be too positive.
Well, 15 off the over so far. Last ball of it. What will Guest do here? He moves and shows his stumps, moves into the leg side. But 15 runs off the over, 125 for six after 15. Not much excitement out there. 111 for four at the same stage with Birmingham. Just shows you how well they batted at the end there with those 89 runs from the last one, two, three, four, five overs.
So they just sort of really went for it in those last five overs, which was made the difference to this score. If they'd have carried on the way they were, then we wouldn't be looking at it going, Derbyshire need to do something special here.
Yeah, it's sort of got away from Derbyshire in those last five overs, which is a real shame. One or two people decided that they've seen enough. They're making their way out of the permanent temporary stand at the far end of the ground, but the crowd has stayed
by and large.
I think so. It's been a very decent crowd. First game of the season.
It's been an all right evening for it as well, weather-wise. A little bit of wind, but not too bad.
Carlos Brathwaite from the City End bowls, and Matty McKinnon has smashed him out towards the mid-wicket region. One bounce, four. Well, well, well. Take that, Carlos Brathwaite. I'm not suggesting that this is the start of a remarkable victory charge, but it's not a bad way to start the over.
No, they seem to have decided that they're going to try and go at the bowls a little bit here, which is, I think, is quite positive, considering the six down.
They need 15 and over, so they have to score some runs, and they can't make too many mistakes. There's another big hit from Matty McKinnon, and that's six over long on. Just for a moment, I thought Jacob Bethel might be in the game at the far distance. But that was a fairly clean hit from Matty McKinnon. And he moves on to 21. And Derbyshire up to 135 for six now. The required rate still 14. They're giving it a go, these two, though.
Yeah, it's making Brathwaite think a little bit about his field. And they're not just putting the ball down and they're just not just going for the singles anymore. They are taking the game to the Bears, which is what you want to see.
Absolutely. Absolutely. After 16 overs, Birmingham are 135 for four. Derbyshire currently 135 for six, and that one is driven along the ground out towards the cover boundary. It goes straight to the fielder out there, who is Chris Benjamin. They pick up another single to move to 136. Halfway through the 16th over, incidentally, and that was after 16 overs, 135 for four. That's when the carnage had begun, I think it's fair to say. Benjamin. No, that's a wide, surely, from Brathwaite. It is a wide from Brathwaite. Brooke Guest couldn't reach it.
They're trying to push those lines, which I think is good from the Bears, but just didn't quite do it there. Trying to make the batters do something.
Which they've got to, haven't they, really, these two? Partnership 38 from 21. Decent. But it probably needs to be the thick end of 80 or 90 to get Derbyshire anywhere near. Guest waits, and that one is guided. That deliberately down to a very fine third man for four runs. No question that was deliberate, is there?
That was a very good shot. He knows that Brathwaite is trying to push that wide line there, and he's backed himself to get it in between the keeper and the short third.
Yep. There are no slips at this stage of a T20. They're still trying to retrieve the ball from down below, I fancy.
There it is.
Oh, it's back. Excellent.
It's got with some pace out as well.
Yes, sort of lodged in the whatever covers are down below. It's Danny Briggs retrieving it. 141 for six now. Brathwaite has gone for 30 runs in his two overs and four balls. And Danny Briggs have just retrieved the ball. Four overs, two for 30. Here is Brathwaite again, bowling to Brooke Guest, who gets a slower delivery and slaps it out into the outside. Are they going to come back for a second? They're not. Probably wisely, as the ball is thrown in to the keeper from out in the cover region. 142 for six. And still Derbyshire are ahead. It makes no sense. They've gone along at nines, Derbyshire, but they need 14 and over. Brathwaite bowls, and that one is carved out into the offside for four runs by Brooke Guest. And Brathwaite stands at the end of his follow-through. Just strokes his chin temporarily, and the 150 is up, is it? No, 146. 146 for six at the end of the over. I make that 21 runs of the Carlos Brathwaite over. I tell you what, this might not be over.
No, this See, I said, you've got to remain positive.
I know, I've been watching Derbyshire for too long though, Lauren. I've been watching them for too long to remain positive.
For.
Yes.
Bring the positive energy.
The positivity.
Energy.
Get the positivity in.
It's all right, I've had a message from Pete Boot at work and he said, stop being so positive.
He knows.
That's for you, Pete.
Pete knows. I'll knock it out of you by the end of the T20, that's what I'm saying. No, it's been a really good season so far from Derbyshire. I don't think there's any question that there are definite signs of improvement. Leicestershire have taken on the mantle of Derbyshire from last season. They are absolutely woeful at the moment. Well, they did win tonight, didn't they? So,
There's tomorrow as well. You never know.
I know. Derbyshire go
don't
to Leicestershire tomorrow.
No,
I know. Oh dear, I shouldn't have said anything. Lintott bowling a new over from the racecourse and an attempt to sweep. Made there by Brooke Guest, barely gets any bat on it at all. Oh, they didn't play tonight, it was Northamptonshire, wasn't it? Northamptonshire.
Oh, yes.
That's who I was thinking of, Durham and Northants. Northamptonshire having been thrashed by 125 runs last night by Birmingham, have won by 31 this evening. Derbyshire 147 for 6, 54 more runs required. That one is a sweep. There's a big appeal for lower leg before. Look at these bowling. I'm sure he appealed for leg before wicket, and the ball has got through, and I'm afraid that Matty McKiernan's got to go. He's been bowled for 26. That's a real shame for McKiernan. He was just starting to get going, was Matty McKiernan. He's the first batsman to be bowled tonight, I believe. And he goes for 26, and Derbyshire 147 for 7 now, requiring 54.
Yeah, it's a bit of a blow that is for Derbyshire. They're starting to really go at the Bears bowlers, but unfortunately not for McKiernan tonight.
But even at the end of 17 overs, they're currently 147 for 7. At the end of 17 overs, Birmingham are 148 for 4. So it's the loss of the wickets, yes,
yeah.
But it was those last 4 overs. Last 3 overs that scuppered Derbyshire, 28, 52 runs off the last 3 overs. And they require 54 now to win Derbyshire. And the new batsman is Mark Watt, I think. Yes, it is. Mark Watt, the Scot. Scotland international. He's seen Scotland over the line a few times in recent weeks. They've been out playing internationals in the Middle East. Lintott comes into bowl, but Alex Davis was still directing the traffic behind...
He's still trying to take his guard as well.
Absolute carnage. Here comes Lintott then, bowls to Mark Watt, who comes down the track and flicks this one into the leg side for a single. Oh, the two there, well, they're going to go back for the second, and they're going to get the second comfortably enough, and that's good running, and 149 for 7 now. Derbyshire. Well, well, well. Oh, they're giving it a good go, in fairness. There have been times when I've watched Derbyshire and T20 cricket when we'd have been doing the post-match interviews by now. I think it's fair to say, as much as I can't imagine that they're going to get over the line in this one, it would be remarkable if they did. This next one is a reverse sweep that comes off the toe end of the Mark Watt's bat.
Watt's decided he's just going to come out and he's going to just play a few shots.
Well,
I think.
It's sort of admirable, sort of. I'm not sure whether it's such a good idea, if I'm honest. I mean, they do need 54 runs at 15 and a half, but... Play some cricket shots first. He hasn't got a lot of time to get himself in, and he drives that down the ground. It's only going to be a single as it's fielded down below us to our right by Adam Hose. Derbyshire 150 is at 150 for 7. Remember their record, our most successful run chase was 193 for 7 here against Birmingham or Warwickshire, depending on what they were called in 2014.
That may still stand after today.
It may.
Going to say May.
Top balls. Oh, now then, that's been smashed. One bounce four. I thought it might have been going for 6 off Brooke Guest's bat, but it didn't. He moves on to 33. One bounce in towards the marquee away to our right. 154 for 7 now, and their requirement is now less than 50, but unfortunately they've only got 3 overs left. I think they're going to fall short. It'd be nice to be...
Anything can happen, Fletch.
Well, anything can happen because Derbyshire beat Yorkshire with 20-odd off the last over when Matt Critchley went berserk at Chesterfield a few years ago, and I'd pretty much given up on that one as well fact, we were doing joint commentaries at the time. And Jonathan Deutsch, I know it was, wasn't Jonathan at all, was it? Tim Steer was commentating for Radio Leeds, and I said, well, you might as well do this out of the talk on. So my commentary didn't appear on Matt Critchley's finest hour with the bat in T20 cricket so far. 154 for seven then. Here is Henry Brooks. 2 overs for 25. Picked up a wicket as well, and he's bowling too. Mark Watt, who's moving around in his crease and falls over as he tries to flick that one away. A no ball. So that'll be a free hit. And 2 runs to the total as well.
There's a lot going on in that ball.
156. He's broken his pad. His pad is his flap. He's just flapping around. I think he needs a new pad here. So there'll be a slight delay to proceedings. But 156 for seven. Derbyshire need 45. From the last 3 overs.
That was a very interesting ball.
It was bizarre, wasn't it? 15 runs and over from here on in. This is a free hit. Alex Hughes is coming out with a new pad. First time I've seen Yoz this evening.
Yeah.
He's been hiding somewhere. Unless he was the man masquerading as Mikey Cohen earlier. I'm sure Mikey's around too. They were the two of the three left out.
Yeah.
The other one was Anoj Dhal. We may see 1, 2, 3 or none of those tomorrow. Remember, 2:30 start tomorrow at Grace Road. Lauren will be with me again with all her positivity.
That's what I'm going to bring to it this year.
Mate, if you can bring it and they provide something to be positive about, everybody's going to be happy. Everybody, believe me.
Should take a little bit of a sweepstake and how long it takes for me to remain positive.
Yeah, game three. 156 for seven. Free hit, I think. We haven't had the free hit yet, have we?
Not yet.
There it comes, and that's another free hit. Surely that was above waist height. I think that's going to be another. It is. It's another no ball. It's gone for four. Hello. What's going on here?
Anything can happen, Henry, Fletch.
Henry Brook is having a shocker. It was only.
He's off.
Of course he's off. He bowled two.
Yeah.
Above waist height.
I forgot about that.
So did I. Henry Brook has gone. He hasn't bowled a legitimate ball in the over yet. And that means Henry Brooks, rather, I keep calling him Brook, I apologise. Henry Brooks would have bowled the last 2 overs from the city end. So Carlos Brathwaite has got to come on and bowl the. Well, it's a full over, actually, isn't it?
This will be his last over.
Ooh.
This makes it interesting.
Doesn't it, just? So Henry Brooks bowled 2 balls, both above waist height.
Miles only got one left. We might see Sterling back on.
Oh, I do hope so. Yes. Yes. There we go. Here we got some stern faces in the BBC WM box next to us now.
What's happening here? Is Brathwaite not bowling?
Well, Brathwaite has removed. I think there's some. I think they're trying to work out who should bowl this over. It's a full over, so it doesn't matter who bowls it, really. And they're giving it to Sterling, which is making a terrible mess of my...
Your sheet is all over the place.
This sheet. I'm ditching this sheet. I thought it was a great idea when I was drawing it up the other day, but I've now realised. Now then, what I will say is the 16th over was going to be bowled by George Scrimshaw. He didn't bowl. Mark Watt did, and he went for 24. This over, started by Henry Brooks, bowled 2 no-balls. Goodness knows how many runs they've got from it so far. 8 runs from it so far. 2 no-balls and a 4. It hasn't even started. Carlos Brathwaite was going to bowl, but now it's going to be Paul Sterling.
And we've got a free hit.
And his first ball's a free hit. Oh, my goodness me.
Bet it's busy in the scorer's box.
Well, Jane looked like she was going somewhere there for a moment, but she sat back down. She's had a quiet evening, hasn't she, in her first game. 162 for seven. Henry Brooks is off. Can't bowl again. Here's Paul Sterling. Around the wicket he comes. It's a free hit and it's a miss. Well, it doesn't matter. You can be stumped as much as you want. It's a free hit.
Davis has tried to claim a run out there. He stumped him.
Not a bad shout. Yes.
On the stump.
Yes, good shout. But no.
Yeah, he's not going to
wave that one. No,
I don't
think.
I like the idea, though.
Yes, it was clever thinking, if that's what the wicketkeeper was doing. Now then, they're going to start this over. In fact, that was the first ball of the over.
it's all going on.
It's absolute madness. And he comes and he's made room for himself and he's trying to sweep it into the leg side as Mark Watt. And I think the chat that they had between Watt and Guest was, get a single and get me on strike. Yes, you can hit the ball a long way, but I've got 33 from 24. 163 for 7. Derbyshire need 39. And that required rate has dropped from 15 to 13 and 3 quarters in just two deliveries. And Paul Sterling is now marking his run-up to come from the other side. He's ready to bowl.
It's never a dull day at Derbyshire.
It is brilliant. In comes Sterling over the wicket, bowls to Guest, who drives it, or slaps it really, down the ground for a single. 164 for 7. At the end of the 18th over, the 19th over from Hayden Kerr was the bad one, really bad one, but at the end of the 18th over, Birmingham are 162 for 4. Derbyshire currently, after three deliveries of the 18th over, are 164 for 7. What can Mark Watt do with this delivery from Sterling? Well, he's danced down the track and he smashed it away for 6. That's huge. That is huge. It's gone into the members' pavilion. Top deck. Terrific blow from Mark Watt, and it is on. It is on.
It always have hope.
I cannot. I genuinely can't believe what I'm seeing. Anuj Dahl signals the 6 on the
he's
big screen.
He's never looked happier, Dahl.
He hasn't, has he? Next delivery. He's down the track again and he gets bat on ball. He pushes it out to Carlos Brathwaite. Goes through for the single. Watt moves to 14 from 9. 171 for 7. Derbyshire need 31 runs. The trouble is, they've only got 14 balls left. Start writing that down as well now. Next delivery is, oh, crack down the ground. Is that gone for 6? It has, off the bat of Brooke Guest this time. He moves to 40. And this is the big over Derbyshire we're looking for. Another 6 signalled by Anuj Dahl on the big screen. The over comes to an end. Does it? Yes, it does. I can't quite believe what I'm seeing here. 177 for 7.
It's keeping the crowd in as well.
23 runs off that over, a combined over from Henry Brooks and Paul Sterling.
Guest has done 40 off 26 balls. Watt going along nicely with his whatever he's trying to do at the other end. 14 off 9.
24 runs required from 12 deliveries. Lauren.
If I was sat at home with my dad right now, we'd be like, we're back in the batting team here. We do it every time.
Here's Carlos Brathwaite in and bowls, and that one is really good delivery in the block hole, and Watt could do nothing with it. Plenty of rowdiness in the crowd.
The crowd is so Craig, chirping up.
Craig Miles will bowl the last over, you would expect.
Yeah.
It's Brathwaite. He's in again, bowls, and that was a full toss. It's driven down the ground, but it's only going to be a single as it goes pretty much straight to the fielder, Adam Hose. 23 from 10. Still possible. Who'd have thought that Derbyshire would have got this close? Well, clearly only one of us in the commentary box. Fielders moving hither and yon all over the place out there.
Everyone is out on the leg side.
Brooke Guest has hit some pretty lusty blows. He's got 3 4s and 2 6s. Brathwaite bowls to him and he smashes it out into the leg side. Oh, it's dropped short of the fielder and they're going to come back for the second. Back they go. He might have to get the dive out here. He doesn't. It hits his back. It dropped short of the fielder. It wasn't a catch. Wasn't a drop catch.
It dropped short.
It just seemed to die on him at the last minute,
yeah,
didn't it?
That is the Derbyshire fans over in the corner there. Loving that.
180.
Oh, look, and insult to injury, he's been replaced as well on the boundary.
Well, that's harsh. We'll get to find out who it was, of course. It's Henry Brooks. He's not had the best few minutes, has he, really? He's taken off for bowling a couple of no balls. This one is hoiked into the leg side. It's not going to beat the man out there in the distance. They think about coming back for the second. They can't get back for the second.
Bit of bounce off of one of the other tracks there as well.
181 for 7. Guest moves on to 43. Derbyshire need 20 from 8 deliveries. They have pushed Birmingham Bears right to the end. couple of sixes now would be very handy from Mark Watt, but it's Craig Brathwaite bowling. Carlos Brathwaite, not Craig. Carlos Brathwaite is in and bowls, and he's driven that down the ground. I'm sure I heard him say one, and one is all they get. And they're slightly disappointed. Adam Hose does the fielding. 182 for seven. 19 required. One ball left of the 19th over, so seven deliveries, 20 runs to win, 19 to tie,
you'd
of course.
You'd like a boundary, but you'd also like guest on strike.
Yes, it's going to be tricky to manufacture.
Oh, it's my ball, though.
It is.
Right in the block hole.
A single taken. So we're down to the last over at the end of 19, 183
here
for seven. Oh, no. Just six runs off that over. That is an outstanding over from Carlos Brathwaite in the circumstances. And his previous over went for 21. So it's a really good comeback. And it will be Craig Miles to bowl the final over. Derbyshire requiring 18 runs from the last six deliveries. And Brooke Guest, well, he's six away from a half century. That will be about the furthest thing from his mind here. Mark Watts batted nicely, 16 from 12. And we may get to speak to Brooke Guest.
I think you found your...
I tell you what, if he gets them home, it'll be remarkable. Here comes Miles then from the City end, bowls to Brooke Guest, who makes room for himself and cuts it away for four. Terrific shot in between the two men, back with a square on the offside. Had to reach a long way for it. It's now 14 from five.
The disbelief.
Well, well, well. 187 for seven. The record run chase was 193 for seven. Here, 2014, Carlos Brathwaite and Craig Miles, the bowler, are deep in conversation. For goodness sake, don't bowl it there, I think is what the captain has said to him. Guest on 48. Miles is in and bowls to him, and he's launched that down the ground for six. That is a huge blow in towards the bar at the far end. Oh my word, they need eight from four, Derbyshire, and Brooke Guest is leading them to victory. A half century for Brooke Guest off 31 balls. This is remarkable.
I'm not quite sure what we're watching right now, to be honest.
We've been wondering all week. I've spoken to a number of people, who's going to be the Derbyshire finisher. Brooke Guest's name never once came up.
Dark horse.
193 for seven, eight runs to win, four balls in which to get them, and there is now a committee meeting at the far end of the ground involving the bowler, his skipper, and presumably the vice captain. Wow.
Jane stood up in the scorebox.
The people who left must be kicking themselves. Here's Miles on his way in and bowls. Oh, a swing and a miss. Eight from three. Seven for a tie. We had a tie last season against Nottinghamshire, which was the worst tie I haven't seen many.
I was going to say, how many ties?
That was
the
only one, I think. It was such an appalling tie. They needed 12 from three overs with five wickets in hand.
I think I was here for that
only
game.
Tied against Notts. I mean, it was embarrassing. This has been thrilling. 193 for seven. Seven to tie, eight to win. Three balls left, and Craig Miles is on his way in. Brooke Guest stands and waits. That's a no ball. Surely that's a no ball. It is a no ball. It's a wide. It's a no ball. That's what we wanted to see. They thought about giving the wide. They've given the no ball. Two onto the total.
Free hit.
I'm not sure it's a free hit.
Is it not a free hit?
I don't think it is. I'm not sure. He hasn't signalled free hit, but it's now six from three balls.
I could take that.
Just take the wide. The wide is clearly better. Well,
I don't think it really matters.
Was it a wide or a no?
No,
it was a no ball.
We had some controversy over the rules this year because ours was signalled as wide this year, but I think it should be no ball.
Yes, that was a no ball, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Two runs from that. 12 off the first three legitimate deliveries of the final over. Derbyshire needs six to win. In comes Craig Miles. Don't need to do it in one blow. That one is one blow. It's out into the distance. It's going to be caught. It is caught. He's gone. That was a no ball. It was. Was it a free hit? I'm not sure that it was a free hit, you know. I don't think it was. And I think that Brooke Guest thought it was a free hit. And he is out. And it means that Derbyshire needs six off two balls. And Brooke Guest has been brilliant. He's made 54. He's been caught out in the deep. And Craig Miles gets his second wicket.
He got a bit of a send-off from the bowler,
though. Did he? Did he indeed? Bethel with the catch. It's Bethel's second catch of the evening. It was a good one as well because he helped to make good ground and took it slow. Sam Connors will face the penultimate ball of the innings. Mark Watt at the other end. Now, what are they doing here? Are they saying if we get a single and a four, we tie, which we do?
Yeah.
Or are they saying to Sam Connors, I mean, it's Mark Watt, because Sam Connors has to face... Doesn't matter that the batsman crossed anymore because that's gone out the window. So Sam Connors will be on strike. Derbyshire need six to win and five to draw, or to tie rather. Sam Connors early in his innings has generally only got one shot. And it's not massively
single,
aggressive.
Then leave it to Watt.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think you're right, Lauren. Anyway, we'll soon find out what they're thinking. Six off two.
No changes to the field.
Yeah.
Left it the same.
What they're going to do here? Miles is on his way in and bowls, and that's a smashed out into the leg side, but it's not going to get to the boundary. They've run one. Sam Connors was very keen to get back for another.
I thought he'd pulled off a little boundary there.
So did I. They need five off the last delivery to win. They need a boundary to tie. I can't stand it. I genuinely can't stand it. The tie last year was woeful. This would be an absolute triumph if they can tie this game here, Derbyshire, with eight wickets down. Carlos Brathwaite talks to Craig Miles. This is what T20 should be like. Both teams effectively scoring 200 runs. It's been an astonishing evening's entertainment here at the County Ground. Where have you been? You should have been here. Come next time, next Friday, Nottinghamshire Outlaws here next Friday. If you can't make it, all frequencies, BBC Radio, Derby, Colsey will be alongside me. Three away games before then. Here we go then. This is the one, and I'm not sure I can stand up without leaning on this wall here. Here we go. Comes down to this last delivery. Mark Watt here at Derbyshire in 2019. Miles is on his way in. Bowls to Watt, who's driven it. Has he got hold of it? He hasn't. And Derbyshire will lose the game, I'm afraid, by four runs. Derbyshire lose by four runs. What a terrific effort it's been, though, by the Derbyshire lower order batsman, effectively. 26 from Matty McKinnon, 54 from Brooke Guest, 17 from Mark Watt. And just the single from Sam Connors. Derbyshire finish on 197. And lose by three runs. Well, it feels like an anticlimax, but it's been a terrific game of cricket, Lauren.
Such a good game to watch, and I mean, we sort of kind of wrote Derbyshire off quite early into the innings there, and they've shown that they can bat deeper than maybe they were expecting to, and it's just been so good to watch. And it's a good advert.
T20 cricket. It is. It feels like a defeat. Well, it is a defeat, but it feels like a really, really bad defeat. But it isn't. Derbyshire battled hard here. It's a very, very good Birmingham Bears side. Paul Sterling didn't score too many runs today. Made 29, as did Alex Davis. 55 from Adam Hose. 43 not out from Chris Benjamin. That was a damaging innings. Chris Benjamin's 23 from Harry Kane, 22 from Lewis Deploy, 20 from Wayne Master. They got in, they got out. 26 from Matty McKinnon, but 54 from Brooke Guest gave Derbyshire hope. They needed to score four runs off the last ball to tie the match. They could only get a single, and they've lost this one by three runs. Absolutely shattering, but they've got to recover quickly because at 2:30 tomorrow they start a game against Leicestershire.
Yeah, and then we can hope by that time that Mark Watt, which has just been pointed out to me, has two pads that are the same shade of blue.
Yeah, one of his pads was destroyed, wasn't it?
I was that into what was going on, I didn't even notice it.
No, I didn't. Lauren, it's been great. It's been a terrific evening's entertainment. Yes. We're going to finish here online and on the club stream. The club streams have probably already disappeared by now in any case. Yeah, I'm going to try and get some reaction, and we'll be back with you tomorrow. Derbyshire losing this one by 3 runs, or Birmingham Bears winning it by 3 runs, depending on your persuasion. Hope you've enjoyed the evening. We certainly have, and we will be back with you tomorrow from 2:30 on BBC Radio Derby, online and via the BBC Sport website and app, for Leicestershire Foxes against Derbyshire Falcons. Thanks for your company tonight. We'll see you tomorrow.